Bowl here in Pittsburgh between the visiting Wagner Seahawks and the Duquesne Dukes. Hi, I'm Ray Goss with former football coach Brian Fleary, now current athletic director at Duquesne University. And Brian, how about assessing this matchup between these two outstanding teams?
I think you have two great coaches. Walt Hamlin, 13 years at Wagner College, been to the postseason 7 times, won a Division III national championship. And Greg Cicuzzo here at Duquesne, who has done an excellent job in his 3 years. Started out 4-6, went through a 6-4 season last year, and 9-1 in the Metro Atlantic Conference Championship.
A couple of interesting aspects to this ballgame, Brian. Certainly Wagner, being in the bowls the last couple of years, have an experience edge, do they not?
Well, I think absolutely. I think, I just mentioned that Walt Hamlin's been in postseason play. It's not a new experience for the Wagner kids. However, the Duquesne kids have really, really come into their own this year. They've improved as the year has gone by. They've won 8 straight. They have a lot of momentum. And they're playing at home, and that's always an advantage.
Speaking of home, we have the artificial surface here, and the Wagner players aren't used to that. It's a very nice facility here at Arthur J. Rooney Field, and I think one of the reasons the game is being played here. Talk about it.
Well, I think, anytime this type of year, at this time of year, the weather always comes into play. And I think, we've had some snow in Pittsburgh this week, but the field is great. And, Wagner had an opportunity to work out here yesterday, and they've played games on turf. I mean, maybe not as many as Duquesne has, but it certainly puts the results of the game in the players' hands and not in the weather.
Two great runners for each team, Bill Green and Tito Lockwood.
Billy Green is a real story, right? Didn't even start until about 15 in his junior year. Came into his own this year, so he's 1,200 yards rushing. Remarkable job. Tito Lockwood, not a good name around Duquesne. 2 years ago, Duquesne kicked a field goal with 50 seconds left to go ahead 24-20. Kicked off. Tito Lockwood ran it back for a touchdown for a Wagner win. So Tito's had a great career at Wagner, also a very fine, a very skilled running back, and I think two of the finest on this 1AA level.
These two teams have met twice before. Wagner's won them both. This is Duquesne's first bowl since January 1st, 1937, when they won in the Orange Bowl 13-12 over Mississippi State. And we'll have the kickoff for today's bowl game between the Duquesne Dukes and the Wagner Seahawks right after this timeout. Get a look at the referee for this ball game. That's Don Woodward with his crew. And we're just about ready to get underway for this ECAC Division I AA bowl in Pittsburgh. Good kickoff, headed downfield and taken at the 7-yard line. DeFazio comes up the near sideline across the 20 to the 27, where the Dukes will put it in play. First and 10. Kevin Gilchrist in on the tackle for the Seahawks.
Andy DeFazio, a freshman, Ray, does a nice job on the return there. He's had a good year. He marked his duty as basically a return man. So
Dukes will have it at the 28-yard line with Loya, the quarterback, under center. Out of the eye set, Green dots the eye, wide out both ways. Fake play action. And incomplete. Thrown behind the intended receiver, Rosado. The Loyal off the mark on the hook pattern at the 40-yard line will bring up 2nd down and 10.
Wagner, a very good team against the rush, right? They've held their opponents to less than 150 yards rushing per game this year. One of the leading teams in the country against the rush. Greg DeCuso goes with a play action here to try to maybe get them stuck up. Loyal just does not connect with Rosado.
Footback this time with deep set Green. Loyal against the 4-man rush. It is Green to the outside. Turns the corner, gets yardage, and is out to the 35-yard line. A pickup of about 8 will bring up 3rd and 2 for the Dukes on their first possession, just underway here at Arthur J. Rooney Field in Pittsburgh.
A nice job of the offensive line there, right? The left side of the offensive line, very strong for Duquesne, and it's been so
sort of the bread and butter that when they go left, they've always had success. So another nice job.
About 3 yards to go on third down. Let's see the situation as Rosado goes to the left, Neely to the right, the two top receivers. They set up in the eye with Loya under center, Brasillo. It is Green, and he'll not get the first down. Stopped a couple of yards short, making the defensive penetration for the Seahawks. It was Jason Scholes, a sophomore D-back who came up, and it'll be punt formation. Bruce Nelson, the punter in for the Duke. Sean Hurley.
Moro Mons out here all by himself. There's nobody coming.
And they throw to him on fourth and two, and he completes it at the 45-50. Mons into Seahawks territory, and how about that for a start? On fourth and two, no one covered Mons, and they threw out a punt formation that worked perfectly for a first down for the Duke.
Obviously, a breakdown on the specialty for Wagner. You know, I'm sure that there's somebody supposed to be out there, and I can see here from the booth. It's sort of an automatic. It's not a call play. It's automatic. Nobody covers the wide out. The punter's to look, and there's nobody there. He throws it, and he comes up for a first down.
That's a 19-yard pickup, and the Duke keeps the drive alive. Loya, deep hand off the Green, swinging to the left. Turns the corner at the 40, 35, and down to around the 31-yard line. Let's see where they say his knee hit the ground. Good run by Green, and again, going left and getting a good block on the corner.
And good job by fullback Tim Gribble leading Green on that play. Did a nice job stealing the corner and getting Green some running.
And it looks like he may have a first down. It's second and short, they're going to call it. At the 30 and a half, he has to get to the 30. So the Duke with an opening drive on a fourth and two pass play out of punt formation when no one covered Mauro Mons. One setback as they slot to the left. Three wideouts. Loya to Green. Left side first down by a couple of yards to spare as he gets inside the 30 near the 28-yard line. The Duke's second first down in this opening drive. It is scoreless with 12:35 remaining in the first quarter.
Nice effort there by Justin Abel, the middle linebacker for Wagner. Does a good job of stopping Green for little, very little ground game, but all first down.
The first series is so important. The Duke can get some points on the board. It's certainly a big lift.
Well, and again, this is like one of those things. You know, he's been good running the ball all year, but you know, Wagner's a very good defense against the run, and he has to be able to throw the ball to the offensive ball.
Gribble goes in motion, now sets up to the right. They run to the right this time with Green. Hit behind a line, and this one is thrown for a loss on the play. Good defensive penetration coming in there to make the initial contact. Bill Summers, a linebacker from Rutherford, New Jersey, a junior at 6'2", 225. A loss back to the 32-yard line, second and 13 for the Duke.
One thing about White Wagner is being down in their last two games. They're down to Mono 20-17, back in 21-20. Last week they're down to San Diego 17-7, back in 20-17. So they're used to being down sometimes.
They've had some magnificent escapes to go 8-1. Back to throw, Loya. Screen left. Green has blocking 30-25, but good recovery defensively and coming up to make the stop to prevent a further gain. It is Ryan Linder. But a gain on a play. It'll bring up third down and about six for the Duke. That looked like it was going to go for bigger yardage.
It did. Good job by Linder. And also, Justin Abel also did a good job of recovering and holding out to just about a five-yard gain for the Duke.
Another key third down play for Duquesne. They'll put Rosado and Neely to the left. And a wideout to the right side, and Hartz is to the left. Hartz comes in motion. It's trips to the right, and Loya looking right. Fires, caught, and dropped. No, he got it. He did get it. I thought he bounced it, but it was just a nice move there, and a first down for the Duke on the throw to Rosado.
I think he got it. He lost the ball, sort of went in between his legs, and then he recovered, and he made the play. It looked like he was going to fall, and he made a recovery. Nice effort by Joe Rosado.
One of the top receivers for the Duke, and a key third down conversion. Keeps the drive alive at the 16-yard line. First and 10 to go for the Duke. Their third first down in this opening drive. 10:40 and ticking in the initial quarter. No score in the ball game, but the Duke, starting from their own 28, have driven the ball deep into Seahawk territory. Split back, and now Green sets deeper. Loya, the quarterback. It is Green getting the call. Swing to the right. And he is down right near the line of scrimmage. Again, good lateral pursuit. As coming over there, Bill Summers, along with Ryan Linder to make the stop to the Seahawks. They are tough to run against.
Well, that's been their success all year, right? They stop the run, stop the run. People that have been effective against Wagner, people have been able to throw the ball, and I think that's what they're looking at today, and that's where Greg Tucson has come in with the intent that they have to be able to throw the ball, because if they can throw it, they'll loosen them up against the run.
Second and a long nine at the 16 of the Seahawks. Neely left, Rosado right. Gribble in the slot to the right. Now he goes in motion right to left. Loya, straight back to throw. Flag down. Flips it, and to Gribble, he pulls it in for the reception at the 13-yard line. Short game, but a flag on the play.
Well, I think you're going to see a legal procedure on the beach there. Right?
Yeah, the legal shift is the indication by the referee, Don Woodward. The option goes to the Seahawks, who they like to take the penalty or the gain to the 13. It would bring up a third and seven, and they're going to take the walk-off. Trying to get him farther out of field goal range, if indeed the Dukes come up dry on the next couple of downs. The walk-off takes it out to the 22-yard line. Second down and 15 for Duquesne. Loya goes over to the sidelines to talk to his coaching staff, led by Greg Gattuso in his third year. Neely left, Rosado to the right, the wideout. The shift into the eye. Loya. Green over the middle. Short yardage inside the 20 to the 19-yard line. And the defensive stop is made by Jason Scholl.
And then you just go to a draw there. You know, good situation, second and 15, and sort of a pass situation. So they go for the draw. We just pick up about six and bring up a third and 12.
And another key third down facing the Dukes. Remember, they converted a fourth and two on a surprise pass out of punt formation when nobody covered Mons on the play. Passing situation, play action. Looking for Rosado, end zone, and no good. Right in the corner of the end zone. Excellent coverage on the play by Jeff Verlato.
Verlato did a very nice job there. Rosado had him beat a little bit, but he made up. While the ball was in the air, he made up some ground and did a good job of deflecting the ball at the last minute.
And here comes Bergman to try a field goal. This will be from the 26, a 36-yard attempt. Slight angle to the left. Bob Nisman, the holder.
Chris Bergman, known here as Duquesne as the toe, right?
Let's see if they can toe one through. Long down. Passing center's a good one. It has the distance, and it is good. Bergman nails a 36-yard field goal. And with 8:34 to go in the first quarter, the Dukes take the lead 3-0 over Wagner. That was a nice drive by the Dukes on the opening possession. And although they came up short of the end zone, Brian, they got some points on the board, and that's what they wanted to do.
Absolutely. I mean, I think the most important thing in the first drive is to get something out of it. And you know, they were stopped in three plays, and it looked like they were going to punt. And a defensive blast by Wagner, you know, and the Dukes taking advantage of it with the punter making the pass tomorrow month to pick up a 19-yard gain and a first down. And gave the Dukes some momentum. Picked up a couple more first downs and got 3 points on the board, and they're ahead of them, and that's where they want to be.
Overcast day here in Pittsburgh, the temperature around 40 degrees. We had rain earlier, but it's a great day for football in the middle of November in Pennsylvania.
Well, there's nothing wrong with it. I mean, it's, you know, and especially on artificial turf. I mean, as we said in the preview, the kids are going to decide the team on the field. The weather's not, the wind's not. It's not one of those things. It's a good day to play football. It's a rather cool fall afternoon.
Don Woodward is the referee. Neil Haynes, the umpire. Headlineman is John Minahan. The line judge is Dean Kula. Daniel Carr, the back judge. And Douglas Hazel, the field judge. The officials working this Division I-AA ECAC Bowl in Pittsburgh. The Dukes' first appearance in a bowl game since January 1st, 1937, when they beat Mississippi State in the Orange Bowl. And that one I do not remember.
Nor do I. I've read a lot about it.
Yeah, that's right.
Especially this week. It's been one of those things, you know, the Duke's on ESPN tonight, put the Duke logo up there, talks about their first bowl game since Mississippi State. So.
Bergman approaches. Gets a high end-over-end kick. Headed downfield and taken at the 10-yard line. across the 20. That's Lockwood, and he comes all the way to the 34-yard line. So first possession for Wagner at their own 34, trailing the Dukes 3-0. Dukes have never beaten the Seahawks 2-0 in the short series. Last game was 2 years ago.
And that was a scary sight right there. The last game ended with Peter Lockwood driving a kickoff out to 50 seconds left in the game for Wagner Wayne. So right there, Chris Bergen kicked it right to him. They got it out of their system.
Jason Miletic, the quarterback, they like to run the football. They average about 35 minutes possession a game. They pull the guard. Miletic, though, will pull you and come back out to the left looking to throw. Now he'll run at 30, 35, hits out of bounds, gets there to the 40. Nice pickup of 6 yards on the first play from scrimmage for the Seahawks.
Looks like the Seahawks are going to go long there. Nice play-action counter type of passing alignment. And they had a couple of receivers deep. Sean Hurley was down near deep, but Miletic decided to keep it and pick up six. And bring up a second and four.
The Duquesne defense will be tested against the Wagner Ball Club. Against common opponents, they're both 3-1, each team losing to Robert Morris from Pittsburgh. Out of the eye set, Lockwood ducks the eye and gets the call on the pitch. And he gets a couple of tough yards as the Duke came up quickly to stop him. Defensively, Kevin Coates in on the tackle with help.
Good effort by Kevin Coates, also good effort there by Mike Orsi and John Wojciechowski, the defensive end does a good job of turning the play back in.
At the 43, third and short, about a yard to go for the first down for the Seahawks to keep their drive alive. Double tight end with one flanker to the right. Dukes are reading run, and they get it from Lockwood. He's hit behind the line. He didn't get it. Great defensive stance by the Dukes.
Well, sort of surprises me a little bit, Ray. I thought they were going to try to go something more of a quick hitter. It looked like Lockwood was trying to get a little bit more outside, and his hesitation led to it just took too much time and the penetration of the Duquesne defense. So, nice effort by the Duquesne defense.
Wojciechowski was one of the first people there for Duquesne. Frankie will punt it for the Dukes. And Rosado in single receiving safety. Line of scrimmage of 43 of Wagner. Pitches away, end over end. Rosado makes a catch in heavy traffic, battles his way to the 27. A gutty catch by Rosado there.
It's been a good job. You know, I mean, Rosado, he did a good job. He caught the ball and he went forward. And he picked up a couple, 3 or 4 yards. And that's how he's supposed to do it. You know, if you can catch it, you can get some positive yards to go for it.
So the Dukes with a 3-0 lead, 7:02 to go in the first quarter. This ECAC Division I AA bowl here in Pittsburgh. They'll come out of the huddle with Dave Loya, the sophomore quarterback, to run the attack. Dribble the fullback, and the deep back is Green. Green gets the call to the left. Nail behind the line, comes back up to about the 25, lost about a yard on the play. Good defensive penetration by Wagner.
Vincent Fife, I think, was the first one in there, right? He did a good job penetrating and slowed Green up. Didn't make the tackle, but he slowed him enough that he got some help.
Mark, a one-yard loss. Mark Price sends him up to put the clamps on him.
Well, you were right earlier, Brian, that they're going to have to pass to loosen up this defense, and maybe then the run will go.
Sometimes you say you run to pass, but you can do the reverse, as you know. Quinn's right. Lawyer rolling right. Two-man pattern. Sideline. Rosado there has a catch at the 43. Beautifully timed pass. Rosado never made the break until the ball was in the air, but that's excellent execution by the Dukes on the first down.
Excellent throw by Dave Loy. And as you said, Ray, I mean, Rosado, the ball's in the air. He turns around, makes the cut. The ball's right there. All he has to do is catch it. Does a nice job doing that. Well executed. Good blocking on the perimeter for Dave Loy by Tim Dribble. So he put down the defensive end, and Dave Loy plenty of time to throw the ball.
17-yard pickup as you watch it.
He dribbled with the block, J.C. Green out front plenty of time. And as you can see, Rosado right there. And just
flag fly as the Dukes line up, but it appears to be against Duquesne for movement. A couple of penalties have hurt the Dukes, but they lead it 3-0 with 6:02 to go in the first quarter. Illegal procedure, the call by Don Woodward, the referee. March it back to the 37, first and 15 for the Dukes. With Ryan Colleary, Ray Goss reporting to from Arthur J. Rooney Field on the campus of Duquesne University in Pittsburgh. Quinn's right, Neely and Rosado, the two favorite receivers for Dave Loya. They're shipped into the eye. And Neely goes in motion. Play action. Good protection. And did Rosado make the catch? No. Trap ball, says the official who slides to make the call. It'll bring up a second down and 15 at the 37 for Duquesne.
Nice effort there by Rosado trying to come up with the ball. Ball a little thrown a little bit behind him, but he tries to make an effort, just comes up a little short.
And then not a bad pass by Loya, because the defender fits a little higher. He may have a better shot at it, so he threw it only where Rosado possibly could catch it.
And also Ryan Linder, the outside linebacker for Wagner, put a lot of pressure on Loya, and he had to get rid of it a little bit sooner than I think he wanted to.
Second and 15. Play action again. This time, excellent protection. He goes for it. Oh, there's a man there, Neely. He's got it in the open at the 20. 15, 10, will not catch him. Touchdown Duquesne as it goes 63 yards for the score, and this lead at 9-0 over Wagner with 5:27 to go in the first quarter.
How about that throw, Ray? I mean, that's an incredible throw. I mean, the ball was right on his fingers. Neely does a great job of getting open, but the ball was put right there. Fabulous throw by Dave Loya.
Absolutely. And Neely, like you say, he must have had stickum on his hands, because I was seeing that ball slipping off, but it just caught right there, and he just legged it in. You knew they wouldn't catch, and he had enough of a lead. And the Duke tally, long distance to lead at 9-0, and Bergman will try to add the extra point. Smithman on the hold. The kick is on its way, and it is perfect. So the Duke lead at 10-0 here early with 5:27 to go in the first quarter. That was a 74-yard drive with a big play, the touchdown pass play. From the quarterback, Dave Loya, to Mark Neely, a junior from Cornell High School.
And Neely did a great job of just beating the defender. I mean, he was in the open by 10 yards. And there's sort of the hardest passes to make when the receiver is wide open like that, and you're the quarterback, and you have to lay it up there. There's so much field. You see Loya with plenty of room here, right?
Excellent protection to start with. That helped.
Good job by the offensive line. And you see Neely, he's ahead by 6 yards.
Look
wide
at that
open,
cap.
The ball
fantastic.
Right on his fingertips. And, excellent effort.
Bergman with the extra point, 10-0. The Duke jumping out on top, just where you want to be in a bowl game like this. Especially when Wagner comes in, you know it's going to be a tough game. They have the experience. They've been in the bowls the last couple of years. This is the third year for the ECAC Bowl. They've been in the last two. They won it 2 years ago and lost last year.
Well, 2 years ago they played. They played Iona, and Iona had beaten them earlier in the year, so it was basically a rematch, and Iona had beaten them 31-14 in the earlier game. They went to Iona and beat them 32-0, so they got their revenge that year.
Bergman for Lockwood. He'll take it at the 11-yard line. Bobbles with a fit, comes across the 20, and lands at around the 25. Good coverage by the Duke. And down there initially, it was Trevor Osborne from Seton LaSalle. A lot of Seton LaSalle grads on this Duquesne team, and of course, Greg Gattuso was a high school coach at Seton LaSalle.
A lot of Western Pennsylvania kids, Ray, really 78 WPIL players on the Duquesne roster. So Coach Gattuso's done his recruiting basically local in Western Pennsylvania.
Maletic, the quarterback, out of the eye set with Lockwood dotting the eye. Lockwood gets the call, goes to the right. Short gain on the play as Nickerman, the defensive leader in tackles for the Dukes, makes the stop from Seton LaSalle. Joe Nickerman.
Also, good help from Mike Orsi, the nose guard.
Gain on the play. Our 3 yards, second and 7, out to the 28-yard line.
The team's also got some outstanding play this year from freshman Matt Fisher, the outside linebacker, has done a great job for a freshman starting this year for the Duquesne defense.
Only one setback, and Maletic with protection. Now he's in trouble, and they've got him. And down he goes as the stop is made on the sack by Mark Rayo. See where they spot the ball at the 22-yard line. It'll bring up third down and 13 for Wagner.
Raio does a nice job beating the offensive tackle there to the outside. And Lennox sort of stepped back from the pocket. Probably should have stepped up. He would have avoided the rush, but Raio was right there for a nice pass. Take another look at it. Raio in there first. Orsi and Wojciechowski helping out. Passing situation now, definitely facing Miletic. He puts his back. Straight back. Standard four-man rush. Miletic steps up. He'll run the football. And he has tumbled down around the 30-yard line as defensively the stop is made by Kevin Coates. It'll be punt formation again for Wagner. Well, the Dukes with a 10-0 lead will see the ball again with 3:33 to go in the first quarter. It looks like he'll come up with a pretty good field position here, Ray. If Rosado can catch this ball and get a little positive yardage, he's going to have a pretty good field position. Frankie has it partially blocked, and it bounces around, and the Dukes pick it up, and racing down the left sideline and being dragged down.
Matt Fisher, it's the freshman Matt Fisher we're talking about, Ray.
Fisher, and he's tackled by Frankie, where he goes in for a touchdown. Big block of a punt by the Dukes as they look for their third score here in the first quarter. The line of scrimmage will be the 15-yard line.
You know, Frankie's first punt, right, he really took a lot of time. They almost got blocked, and there was no pressure at all on him. I think the Dukes went a little after this one to say, hey, let's take a shot at this. And,
The Dukes will stop the clock with a timeout here and talk things over with Brian Kaleri, Ray Goss reporting to you from Duquesne University as you get a good shot of the Mon River here. The Dukes with first and 10 at the 15 after the block punt by Amick. And Loya looking for it all, throws short, caught by Dribble out of the backfield at the 10 down to the 7. And the touchdown saving tackle made defensively by Jason Scholes. A pickup of about 7 on the play, make it almost 8. It'll be 2nd and 2 for the Dukes.
Dukes doing a good job of getting Loya time to throw the ball and throwing the ball very effectively. So, I think, you know, early on we said that's important. And they're doing an excellent job on first downs, getting positive yardage and giving the option run pass and keeping Wagner's defense off balance.
2:38 to go in the first quarter. The Dukes leading 10-0 and looking for more after the block punt. Loya with 2nd and 2 at the 7. Green to his right, nailed for a loss back at the 10. And coming in there, shooting the gap and making the big stop, it was Ryan Linder. He's a sophomore, 5'10", 215-pound linebacker from Piscataway, New Jersey.
Linder does a nice job of penetration and takes Green down one-on-one. And, that hasn't been done that many times this year.
Green, the workhorse back, 248 carries for 1,427 yards, 9 touchdowns. He's also had 14 receptions for 95 yards and a TD coming in to this ball game. Passing situation, Loya loops it out, a screen to Green, one man to beat, can't do it as he's nailed at the 15-yard line and making the tackle, Jeremy Gilbert. He snuffed it out and he made the solo stop, a big play. It'll force a field goal attempt by the Dukes.
And Wagner was coming all out. They blitzed everybody on that play, Ray. And it looked like a good call, but Gilbert did a great job of making a one-on-one tackle. He doesn't make that tackle, that's the score.
Dukes will attempt a field goal. And Bergman again, the snapper, is Keithy. It'll be a 32-yarder. Slight angle to the left. Nisman the holder. Pass from center is a good one. Kick has the distance, and it is perfect. So with 101 to go in the first quarter, Bergman adds another field goal, and the Dukes lead at 13-0 over Wagner.
Well, Wagner, as I mentioned earlier, they have started slow in their last several games. As a matter of fact, they've come behind on 4 different occasions to win, but last week or 2 weeks they were down 27 in the first quarter, down 20-0, came back one at 21-20. Last week they're down 17-0 to San Diego, came back and ended up winning that 20-17. So, the good thing is Duquesne's in the lead. The bad thing is Wagner used to come from behind, so just have to be aware.
And I'm sure Greg Gattuso wants his biggest lead.
possible, so there's not enough clock left to come back in the fourth quarter.
But it looks like, I mean, the Wagner kids this year have faced adversity several times and found a way to win. And I'm sure that's what Walt Hamline's going to be telling these kids. Hey, we've been down before, and I'm sure that Greg Kadish is going to tell his kids, hey, they're coming behind 2 or 3 weeks in a row, so you can't let up.
Tito Lockwood has run back the first two kickoffs, and with him back there, number four is their other fine running back, Rich Surreal. He replaced Lockwood when he was injured, and he's an outstanding runner. Bergman to boot it off. 13-0 to Duke. He really gets it up there. Lockwood drifting back. Will take it at the 1 yard line. Far sideline return. 10. Slides down as he slips on the artificial surface trying to make a cut. So the worst field position to start with for the Seahawks around their 16-yard line.
And it's still been a little tentative on offense so far this afternoon. It'll be interesting to see what Walt Hamline comes up on this series. Now you're down 2 touchdowns. They have to put a couple of first downs together. They have to get a drive. They have to get a little momentum going. They really should have been out of sync offense.
We'll see if they change their game plan at all. They like to run the football. Miletic the quarterback. And Miletic play action to his left. Fires down the sideline on the comeback pattern, sliding at the sideline. Incomplete. On the sideline was the intended receiver, Kevin Daniel. So it's 2nd and 10 from the 16-yard line for the Seahawks.
And Miletic took a little too long to throw that ball. He had his receiver open, and Daniel was down there, and he ran a nice pattern, was open, and Miletic just came up a little short, a little too late, and sort of let him out of bounds.
Duke with all the momentum here, but this is a four-quarter game, and we still have almost three-quarters plus to go. 50 seconds remaining in the first. 13-0, Duquesne with a touchdown and 2 field goals. One setback. The draw goes to Surreal. He comes over the middle, and he gets to the 25-yard line. So that was Jarosky, correction, number 60 fullback, running the football.
Looks like he's a little bit injured.
Yeah,
here.
He is.
Nice effort. He picked up just about 10. It's going to be real close to a first down.
And they attend to Jarosky on the field on the pickup right up the middle. Jarosky goes off. He seems to be all right. It is 3rd and short at the 25 for the Seahawks. Fumble, picking it up. There's Miletic trying to leg it for the first down. Gets it as he gets out to the 30-yard line. Wagner was fortunate there. Miletic, who can run the football, did on that occasion.
Well, you got a lucky bounce, too. You know, that ball takes funny bounces, and that was just going to be a little plus there. The ball bounces, and you know when that happens, defenders also go towards the ball, and their natural instincts, and Miletic picked it up and ends up getting the first down. And Wagner really needed that first down.
Bob Nittman, senior D-back, came up to make the stop for the Duke. Line of scrimmage is 30-yard line for Wagner as the clock ticking down. I don't think we'll get another playoff here before the quarter. And there it is, the end of the first quarter in this ECAC Division I AA bowl game from Arthur J. Rooney Field on the campus of Duquesne University in Pittsburgh with a score. The Duquesne Dukes 13, the Wagner Seahawks nothing.
Careers in their lives. It is so important for college students to be in touch with the real world. And Wagner is the only college anywhere that sits atop a hill overlooking Manhattan, the richest cultural center in the world, and at the top of the professional ladder. At Wagner College, you're reminded every day that your highest aspirations truly are within reach.
What?
What's a girl got to do to get on one of these commercials? What would you do to be in a beer commercial?
Everybody here is freaking our city. I can see that tonight.
Yeah, yeah. I see the light.
Like a champ. Wake up with the all-new Breakfast Jam on 106 Jam's WAMO.
Containing only the finest ingredients.
Nutritionally balanced for good, healthy fun.
Mark John and Lisa Allen, along with Tracy Ross, Tony Giordano, and Debbie Norrell, are your all-new Breakfast Jam.
Now there's a new ingredient, Steeler Safety
Smile Lake and the all-new Breakfast Jam on 106 Jam WAMO.
Hey, don't make me go car shopping, okay?
Let's get a root canal.
Let's do our taxes again. Let's
go visit your mother.
Let's eat some pickled eggs and warm the dog.
Car shopping?
I don't think so.
Let's go to Beatty Chevrolet,
where the only thing lower than the price is the pressure.
Beatty Chevrolet.
Carnegie Exit Parkway West or I-79.
So very nice.
Mileta getting attention on the field. We'll be able to take a look and see Wojciechowski beat his man and wraps up Mileniak there, and Mileniak trying to get away. And he gets help there from number 45, Todd Amick. And difficult to see what the injury is to the leg, it appears, as they treat him. And he's got it twisted underneath him when he went down, trying to fight that off that tackle by Wojciechowski. Well, it's Brian the Duke performing extremely well in this bowl game. Not awed at all by Wagner's experience coming in here just doing what they want to do.
Well, you know, I think, you know, one of the critical things or important things is the comfort level. They're at home. You know, they slept in their residence halls last night. They're in their locker room. So, yeah, you know, it's not one of those things that you have to travel and be in a bus, be in a hotel. They could stay focused, and I think the coach has done a good job this week of preparing them for this trip. And so far, they've reacted very well.
Mileniak will go to the sideline. Brad Chernovitz will come in to replace him. He's a freshman, 6'4", 210 pounder from Suffield Academy in Connecticut. Nice size. And he'll see if he goes out of the shotgun here with third and long. They marked the last scrimmage at the 23 at third and 17. Chernovitz will pass. He gets deep. He steps up. He avoids the pressure. He fires to the sideline. Incomplete as he overthrew his intended receiver, Jim Bogacki. So it'll be punt formation again for the Wagner Seahawks.
And Chernovitz, he did a good job there. I mean, he comes off the bench. He hasn't played a play. He put him back in the shotgun. He gets some pressure. He avoids it. And, makes a pretty good throw. Just doesn't connect.
Well, Frankie will try to punt again. Last time they blocked it. First time they came close. Let's see if he gets it away a little more quickly. Rosado to receive. And let's see if the Duke go again with a rush. They're coming. And the kick is away. It'll bounce. Bounces laterally around the 45-yard line. And the Duke will have excellent field position at their own 46, leading 13-0 over Wagner with 13:36 to go in the second quarter.
Good pressure also on that punt by Todd Amick. He's right in there again and sort of forced Frankie to kick it sideways, and therefore he could get no depth on the punt, and it was a sort of line drive, and he could end up with good field position.
Dave Loya in to pilot the attack for the Dukes on the season. 108 for 188 in his passing. Excellent 57% completion for 1,667 yards, a Duquesne record. 11 touchdowns, only 5 INTs. Green gets the call. Left side gets only a couple as a trip-up tackle is made defensively by Mike Bugnasco.
Bugnasco does a real nice job there, beating the offensive line, comes over and makes the tackle on Green and holds him to just a very short game.
Second and 9 for the Dukes at their own 47-yard line. Dukes come out of the huddle. They send Rosado to the right. Twins to the right, actually, also out there with him. It is Neely. And back to throw, four-man pattern. Deep over the middle again, way overthrown, going for Neely on the post, but he overthrew him that time. Coverage by Jeff Perlotto for the Seahawks.
It looks like they're trying to isolate Neely with Perlotto one-on-one. That's what they did on the touchdown pass. And it looked like, again, they go into a spread formation. Wagner in a man-to-man defensive set there, and the matchup Neely with Perlotto trying to go for him.
Todd Twinner in the ball game for the Duke. Third and 9 for Duquesne. Loya, play action, loops it over the middle, Twinner overthrown at the 30-yard line. He had him. good effort, and obviously good job by the coaches to see that. Bruce Nelson will punt for the Duke. Brian Cornell, the long snapper, as back to receive, Sean Hurley. He gets it away, wobbly kick, and bounces. Duke's try to get out of the way of it, and it's down around the 22-yard line by Nisman. So Wagner will put it in play. Duquesne leading 13-0 with 12:41 to go in the second quarter here at Arthur J. Rooney Field in Pittsburgh.
And, you know, the Dukes in that series sort of went for it, right? I mean, they went to Neely deep, and they went to Schwinner deep. They're trying to put this one away. You know, Coach Pizza on the staff probably looking to say, hey, listen, we can get one more. We can get them to start hanging their heads and, you know, went for the big ones there.
Jason Miletic is back. He was injured in the previous series. Out of the eye set with Lockwood dotting the eye, gets the pitch. Left side, gets some good yardage as he comes across the 25 out near the 30-yard line for the Seahawks. Defensively, up from the secondary to make the stop for the Duke, Bill Sepik. Sepik leads the Duke with four interceptions. The gain is to the 29 plus 6 yards, second and four.
I think you might see Wagner getting sort of back to basics here. They have to get some type of some feel for this game. Offense has really struggled with the pressure, you know, every time they tried to throw. And you might see him getting back to basics, just running the ball, seeing they do the best.
Archie Dean in motion, and is Lockwood to the left side again, looking for first down yardage. Maybe a bit short around the 32-yard line as he's rolled out of bounds across the way. And up there again was Sepich with help on the play. Also, Joe Neckerman. The official's looking over the situation. And it's going to be just shy of a first down, third and less than a yard for Wagner. Last time, you remember when they had this situation, they handed deep to Lockwood, and the Duke stopped them.
Yeah, well, and as I said, I was a little surprised they didn't go to, you know, either a sneak or a pullback guy, something real quick. They need guys quick here. And anytime you go back, you can take the possibility of losing yards.
Mm-hmm. They go with a full house backfield, the old T formation. And this is a quick hitter. Lockwood fights his way forward and appears to have the first down as he's near the 35-yard line. That time they went, took your advice, Brian, and went with the quick hitter.
Well, I mean, you know, that's one of Wagner has always been a very good red zone type of team. They get low in the head. Always a very good short yardage offense. And the last two times they had short yardage, they sort of just went out of the regular set. There they went into their goal line type of set, a full house or wishbone type look, and just tried to power people.
First down at the 34 for Wagner in their own territory. This drive started at their 23. The Dukes lead it 13-0, 11:40 to go to halftime. Miletic puts the man in motion. He rolls to the right. Wojciechowski with backside pressure. And he's got him. Picked him up. What an effort by Wojciechowski. He ran halfway across the field to get him, and he got him right at the line of scrimmage.
And you know, that was a scary play because Miletic didn't know he was there. He almost took the ball up. Wojciechowski would have had a great shot at him and could have been able to cause a fumble there. See Wojciechowski coming. See, Miletic has no idea he's there. And Wojciechowski just... His instinct leads him to run, and Wojciechowski gets his arm on him and trips him up.
Gave him about a yard on the play, close to the 35, second down and nine. Archie Dean goes wide to the left, and to the right is Kevin Daniel.
Play clock down to four here, Ray. They're going to look at a delay of game if they don't watch out.
They got it if they call it. It was right at zero, and they did get it. Good call, Brian. A five-yard walk-off will occur. That time, Miletic wasn't paying attention. He was about a half a second late.
Sure, and I, you know, those clocks are right there. They're staring you in the face. You have to, when you're a quarterback, you've got certain leadership. And I'm sure Coach Hamline will remind him when he comes to the sidelines.
A walk-off takes it back to the Seahawks 30-yard line. It'll bring up second down and 14. Duke's pitching a shutout thus far, but this one has a long way to go. Wagner is averaging 30.4 points a game, the Duke 28.3. Wagner allowing 15.8, the Duke 19.5. Lockwood over the middle. Wojciechowski again on the ankle, makes the tackle at the 33-yard line.
Some help with Mike Orsi and Kevin Fish also in on the tackle, so good team defense on that play. Right now.
Third and 11 for Wagner. As they make some changes, Jim Bogacki, 6'5 senior tight end, 260-pounder, comes into the ballgame, passing situation facing Jason Maletic. He'll work out of the shotgun. Dukes with a standard four-man run. He gets good protection. The throw over to middle Lockwood, trying to work him in the open field. And he breaks the tackle across the 45 to the 50 to the 48-yard line. And a blocked tackle by the Dukes, Brian Cornell, or Lockwood is still running.
It looked like the Dukes were going to do a good job there. I mean, Maletic did a good job hitting Lockwood over the middle, but they needed 13 on a play. And Cornell had him just about 2 or 3 yards short of that first down marker. But you have to give Lockwood some credit. He broke the tackle and picked up the first down.
He got it to him in the open field, and he knew what to do with it. So Wagner showing some offensive spark, really, for the first time this afternoon. 9:27 to go until halftime. 13-0, the Dukes with a lead on a touchdown and a couple of field goals. Lockwood gets the call. No, this is the other back who comes across the 40, down to 35, and pushed out of bounds as Rick Surreal, the freshman, who is an excellent runner. He replaced Lockwood earlier in the season, and in his first game against St. Peter's, ripped off 271 yards rushing. And you can tell he's got some get up and go, Brian.
Well, and I, you know, I was with Walt Hamline. You can take a look on. I was with Walt Hamline. I had the opportunity to speak with him last night. He said he was, you know, once he put the girl in there and he did what he did, it was such a, you know, that he had this great problem. Theo Lockwood, a great back, and there was a freshman coming up behind him, so he's got the two great backs and didn't know what to do with him for a while.
Lockwood gets the call and gets hammered right near the line of scrimmage, the Duquesne 34-yard line.
You know, trying to get them both carries, trying to get them both time, but he said that Starley, I mean, he knew that he was a good back, but he was shocked at the progress he made.
Neckerman on that big hit by the Dukes on Lockwood. So it's second down and 10, but the Seahawks with their best drive of the day, starting at their own 23, they're at the Duquesne 34, second and 10. 8:43 till halftime, Duquesne leading 13-0, and Maletic will go out of the shotgun. Wide out both ways. Back to pass. A lot of time. Hesitate. Will run the football and get nailed as Wojciechowski is one of the tacklers there for the Dukes with help on the play as Mark Rayo also greets Maletic, and they deposit him on the turf at the 35-yard line. A loss of one will be third and 11.
Maletic was looking to run all along there. He just was sort of looking for a seam. I'm not sure it wasn't a quarterback draw as we take another look at it here, but the Dukes did a good job of closing the hole. But he had a lot of room to run. How he got, you know, had he broken the line of scrimmage.
Maletic will work out of the shotgun once again. Kevin Daniel is wide to the right. And Archie Dean to the left. Good protection again. He throws. Man here. Lockwood drops the ball in the wide open at the 33-yard line. He had a man bearing down on him. Bill Steppage. So let's see what they do here on fourth down and 11. You're down 13-0. Coach Brian Cleary, what's the call?
Well, you're sort of in a predicament here. I'm not so sure that you're going to take a look at this pass to Lockwood. Right in hand, he drops it. Steppage, as you said, and, you know, unless Lockwood breaks the tackle, that's not going to get you a first down anyway. It looks like it. I mean,
they're going to go for it.
You're on the 35-yard line. I mean, you know, you're going to punt. If it goes in the end zone, you pick up a net of 15 yards. And it's, you know, it's a bowl game. It's the last game of the year you go for it.
They put trips to the right. Among them, Lockwood. And rolling to the right, getting some heat. He steps up. The pass all open and complete down to the 8-yard line is the wide receiver, Kevin Daniel. Big conversion on 4th and 11 at the 35. First and goal for the Seahawks.
And a nice play there by Maletic. He did a good job of delivering the ball. Daniel runs a nice pattern, runs it out, comes to the sideline, and is wide open. Maletic does a good job delivering the ball for a first down.
27 yards.
Maletic right there. You see Daniels down here, wide open, and right in front of Nixon. And
Surreal gets the call. 5. He's heading for the end zone. He's in, standing up for the score. And with 7:38 to go till halftime, Wagner is right back in it. They trail 13-6 as Surreal took it in from 8 yards out.
Surreal has certainly a great burst of speed. I mean, the carries he's done, he's shown great speed, great ability. I mean, he just took off right there, Rip.
You would not be denied.
But he gives you a much different look than Lockwood. Lockwood's more of a, you know, power runner, and Earl's more of a skilled, you know, shifty type runner, and really he's got great speed and get in, and there's a quite a difference in their approach to down the ball.
Frankie for the extra point. Got a big rush, but he boots it through there, and it's 13-7. And this Wagner team is right back in it. That was a 77-yard drive. And this game heats up. 7:38 to go to halftime. 13-7 in favor of the Dukes over Wagner. We'll be back right after this timeout.
In a world of conflict, we bring peace through understanding. In a world of economic distress, we bring prosperity through learning. In a world of ignorance, we bring knowledge through advanced technology and brilliant teachers. In a world of despair, we bring hope to thousands. In this complex world, the solution is education of the mind, the heart, and the soul. Duquesne University.
Breaks the tackle. He's at the 30 to 35-yard line. Excellent return by Rosado. And making the tackle, where Rosado's still running, it was Jason Scholl.
The starting free safety also on special teams. Schultz does a good job of saving a big return right there.
Well, Wagner, you didn't think they were going to pack their tent in and head back to New York State. They're right back in this.
As I said earlier, I mean, they're sort of where they're accustomed to being. When they're down, I guess they sort of spark the light in them or something, but they certainly didn't appear to be ready to play right off the bat, but they're in the game now.
It's up to the Dukes now to see what they can do offensively, and Green gets the call, comes over the middle. Spins out of the arms of one tackler, but then he's nailed. Nothing but white shirts around him, got maybe a yard to the 36. And on the bottom for the Seahawks, Kevin Moran, topped out by Justin Abel. Gain of one, second and nine for Duquesne.
And that's what your coach Kadeem has to be worried about. I mean, Wagner's going to gang up on the line of scrimmage. He knows it, you know, and that's why they're going to have to take a look at throwing the ball a little bit more, because on more occasions, especially on first down, because if they stop you on first down, then they force you into a second and third and long, and they get you where they want.
Little mix-up by Duquesne is Neely and Rosado were both heading one way, then went to the other way. And Loya calls a timeout. So with 6:50 to go in the half, the Dukes leading 13-7 over Wagner. We'll be back right after this timeout.
In a world of conflict, we bring peace through understanding. In a world of economic distress, we bring prosperity through learning. In a world of ignorance, we bring knowledge through advanced technology and brilliant teachers. In a world of despair, we bring hope to thousands. In this complex world, the solution is education for the mind, the heart, and the soul. Duquesne University.
Short, but he makes a great effort, a catchable ball, and he makes a good catch, and gives the Dukes a big lift.
That's a 28-yard pickup as we watch it. Look at the heat he's getting from the backside. Loya, nice delivery, and watch this grab. Fantastic.
Gets his feet inbounds, and you know, that's how they're coached.
28-yard pickup. Gribble gets the call in the middle, spins out of the arms of one tackler, and Powell drives his way forward down to around the 30-yard line. So the Dukes, after scoring the first 13 points in this game, see the Seahawks come back with a 77-yard drive, convert a big fourth down play, and score. Now Duquesne trying to re-grab that two-score advantage, leading by only six. The gain is to the 31. It's a five-yard pickup for Gribble, the fullback, second and five. 6:14 till halftime. Twins to the right. Neely and Rosado, the top receivers for the Duke, repositioning Green to deep back. Motion man is Gribble. Does that mean they're going left? They sure are. To the left side. Green hit near the line of scrimmage and brought down on a good tackle.
Man, let me tell you something. That tackle by number one sort of saved the day here. And I think it's a number change, right?
It is.
That's Richard Reed.
It is. That's who it is.
And it's a number change, and that's why he's not here. But if he doesn't make that tackle, they did a great job on that left side of the offensive line.
Green with a tremendous career here at Duquesne. It's third down and three for Duquesne. offset eye, lawyer, straight back, quick one, overthrows his Nintendo Rosado. He was open. Now a decision for the Dish at the 29-yard line. They're in four down territory as they go for the long field goal.
What are these surprised to see if they don't go for it, they see a good Bergman a chance. I mean, he's got a good leg, but it looks like they're just going to go for it.
They need to get to the 26, so it's 4th and 3. Schwinder coming out of the ball game. Lawyer conferring with Coach Greg Gattuso on the sideline, as he does on every offensive play, prior to relaying the selection to his teammates. Three wide receivers. John Hartz to the right. Back to throw. A quickie out. Man there. Complete first down. Neely with the grab on the 4th and 3. They take it to the 20. They needed 3. They got 9 on the play, so that'll keep the drive alive for the Duke.
And basically, the exact same play, just a different formation, different receiver out there. Goes out about 6, turns around, and had plenty of cushion. The Wagner defender getting plenty of cushion. And Lloyd does a good job delivering the ball for the first down.
Duke's on a drive that started at their own 35-yard line following the kickoff and the Wagner touchdown. 5 minutes to go to halftime. Rosado in motion, split back, passing formation. They look for Neely. They fake him. He's open in the end zone, and he's there for the score. Beautiful execution by the Duke. 20 yards and a touchdown, and the Duke's now lead it 19-7 with 4:51 to go to halftime, a flag in the end zone after the play.
Yeah, that'll be excessive celebration there, Ray. That'll be marked off on the kickoff. I think Mark Neely celebrated a little too much in the official's eyes.
That's a 65-yard drive. That time they fake the short pass, and Neely suckered in the defender, and he was wide open, wasn't he, Brian?
Sure he was. And Lawyer did a good job there. I mean, people couldn't see it, but I mean, Lawyer did a good job because he had some pressure, was about to be sacked, stepped out of the pressure, and just had enough time to deliver that ball.
The penalty will occur on the kickoff. Unsportsmanlike conduct against the Duke. Christian Kesey will snap it on the extra point. Bob Nissen, the holder. And the toe, Chris Bergman, looking for the extra point. He has 2 field goals and a PAT thus far. Long count. And the kick is right there, and it's 20-7. The Duke leaded with 4:51 to go to halftime. So that's what you want to do when the other team gets back in, and it's answer right back with a scoring drive. And the Duke did it, Brian.
They sure did. And that's exactly what you want to do. When the team starts to get momentum, you try to inflate it. You try to take the ball, and great offensive drive there by the Duke. You see Lawyer here. He'll take the ball, and you'll see the pressure he gets, right? He's back in the pocket. Does a good job.
That's the short pass.
That's the short one.
Oh. I thought so, because the touchdown was 20 yards, not 30. That was the first down play, and that's how that set up the TD play. I think we'll have that replay coming up for you. When I saw that replay, I thought he threw it from the 20, not the 30.
I also knew he faked. It was a pretty good fake. The ball went out of the corner.
4:51 to halftime. This is the ECAC Division 1 AA ball. And now we'll see the touchdown play.
You see Lawyer getting pressure, and he buys a little time as he goes left here, knowing that he has a receiver open. He just needed that extra second. He does a good job avoiding the pressure. And here you see Neely wide open, just backpedaling in the end zone.
And the thing that Lawyer did so beautifully, he just lofted it out there. He didn't want to risk throwing it too hard or too far or anything like that. It was like a fair catch in the end zone by Neely.
He has excellent touch there. Dave Lawyer has gained a lot of poise, and he wasn't even a good starter early in the year. He's got a starting on the second game and has held it since then and done a remarkable job.
Now the 15-yard misconduct penalty means that this will kick off from the 20-yard line. And let's see how Bergman does here. A lot of times the kicker will try to just boot it too far here. So let's see what Bergman does. Wagner should have pretty good position. His kickoff into a crossing wind is fielded at the 32-yard line. As Surreal has it, runs laterally at the 35 and then slips down around the 39 and a flag flies.
There might be a...
Trevor Osborne was on the tackle.
Yeah, I think there was a block in the back from behind there by the Seahawks, so they'll have to walk that one off.
Exactly. So that'll hurt their field position. Instead of having it at the 39, they'll march back. 3 fours on the board, 4:44 till halftime. Duquesne 20, Wagner 7. Dukes come in the MAC champions at 9-1, Wagner at 8-1. All the way back to the 24-yard line, so the Seahawks put it in play, first and 10 to go.
That really hurts. I mean, that's a big, big penalty. I mean, instead of starting off, you know, almost at the 40-yard line, needing 60 yards to get on, you know, to get on the board again, the Seahawks are back on their own 24.
Jason Maletic, the junior quarterback from Palisades Park, New Jersey, in to direct the attack. Good size at 6'3", 210. Lockwood dots the I. Lockwood gets the call. Over the middle, big hole. 30, 35, out to the 40-yard line. So he gets it back to where the kickoff was taken. That's how to do it. Lockwood right up the gut. And he takes it to the 41.
Nice execution there by the Wagner offensive line. Good size on the Wagner offensive line. Three all-East players back from last year's team. And they've done a good job here in the second quarter offensively.
From the 41. Wideouts both ways, out of the eye set. Still a lot of clock till halftime, so Lockwood gets the call again and gets out to the 45-yard line. And it's defensively for the Dukes in on the tackle, Kevin Coates, sophomore from West Allegheny High School. Second and 6 for the Seahawks as we wind it down to 4 minutes till halftime. This is a huge part of the game here. If the Seahawks can come down and score, it's close at halftime. The Dukes would love to close them off here.
Well, I mean, this is, I mean, the type of game you sort of expected is both teams to be able to go back and forth scoring. And I, you know, I think that's the type of game you're going
to take. Six led at the end of one, 13-0. Lockwood over the middle, picks his way to the 50, and has a first down to the 47 of the Dukes before he is stopped in that secondary by Matt Fisher. He has good vision, doesn't he, Lockwood? He looks left, right, makes these little shifty moves, and he finds the hole. They mark him down at the 46 of the Dukes.
Excellent block there by Matt Runge there. He did a good job of executing at the line of scrimmage and making a nice hole for Lockwood.
Lockwood will get a breather as Cyril, the freshman tailback, is very quick, will dot the I. Zeronski is the up back. And Cyril gets the call, waits for the block, and slips down, having some trouble with the footing.
And that's, I was saying earlier, he gives you such a different look, Cyril, but he's a real shifty, cutting type brother. And the surf, I mean, there's been rain, so it's down deep, it's moist. So, he's just got to get accustomed to cutting a little bit more efficiently.
They do not play at home, of course, on artificial turf. They haven't all year. They practiced this week, and, of course, they practiced yesterday, trying to get used to the artificial turf. Twins left. Actually, he trips to the left now as they set up in the slot with Cyril. Passing situation, flag down, and rolling off Maletic, throws, underthrows his receiver as Wojciechowski puts pressure on the quarterback.
So there's going to be an illegal motion there on Wagner. Fullback sort of jumps a little bit. I think the Dukes will probably decline this and bring up a third and 10.
Exactly. 2:37 till halftime, 20-7, Duquesne leads it. Here at Arthur J. Rooney Field on the campus of Duquesne University in Pittsburgh. The third annual ECAT Division I AA Bowl. And the backfield in motion is declined. A lot of clock remaining in the second period, so this is a big third down play. The Dukes can hold, they'll force a Seahawks punt. But if the Seahawks can keep the drive alive and going and for a score, they're right in it at halftime. Not that they're out of it, down 13. Back to throw. Good protection. Maletic has a man there. His big tight end. Oh, they have to bring him down with a couple of people. He is a monster catching that ball. Bogacki, 6'5", 260.
Bogacki, the last two games, he's had the two-game winning reception. Reception last week against San Diego and the week before against Monmouth. Touchdown pass in the last 2 minutes to win both teams.
And they're at the 39, fourth and 3, and the Seahawks want to talk it over. I think they're going to go for it, Brian. 2:12 till halftime.
Well, you know, once again, it's a tough decision. You know, you try to punish it, you came down deep, try to use your timeout, maybe get the ball back with 30 or 40 seconds left and use your timeout wisely. Or do you take a shot at it, you know? And, I mean, Walt Hamline's been coaching 13 years. I mean, he's been a head coach 13 years. It's one of those things. His decision is going to be what he goes with and what he feels inside. I'd be surprised to see if he doesn't go for it. Good shot at the city of Pittsburgh. 20-7, the Dukes lead it. There's a timeout on the field.
In a world of conflict, we bring peace through understanding. In a world of economic distress, we bring prosperity through learning. In a world of ignorance, we bring knowledge through advanced technology and brilliant teachers. In a world of despair, we bring hope to thousands. In this complex world, the solution is education for the mind, the heart, and the soul. Duquesne University.
Miletic rolling to his right, the pass on 4th and 3. They come! And a big sack by the Duke. A shirt-grabbing sack by Duquesne's Mark Rayo. Excellent effort there by Rayo. Miletic sort of was fading. You know, he wasn't really threatening the corner, and Rayo just ran him down.
Duke gets good field position too. Not only stop them, but they pick up probably about 5 or 6 on the play.
And 2:05 remaining till halftime as the players congratulate Rayo on the sideline. So the Duke looking to stop Wagner from scoring. Now they're thinking of 3 or 7. Loya, the quarterback, from the 45-yard line. Play action over the middle. Man here, Schwinner has it inside the 40. Fights his way to the 37-yard line of the Seahawks as Jason Scholes makes the tackle.
A nice effort by Schwinner. Great throw by Dave Loya. And honestly, the team could have found something over the middle against the Wagner defense. And Schwinner is open there and did a good job of catching the ball. But Loya did a good job of delivering the ball.
It's to the 32-yard line, a 23-yard pickup for the Duke. And Loya again to throw. Screen left. And it is Green with room. He goes to the 25-yard line. Pickup of 8 on the play. 1:37 till halftime. The Duke's going with a hurry up.
Nice effort there by Jeremy Gilbert to make that tackle on Green. Second time Gilbert made a tackle on a screen that helped it from being a big play.
See if they run for the first down, but back to throw Loya again. Fires over the middle. There's Schwinner. He has it, and he's down to the 10-yard line. They're finding the big tight end, and it's first down for the Duke with 1:19 to halftime. They stop the clock momentarily to reset the chains.
Duke has some timeouts remaining.
Yes, they do. They're at the 10. First and 10 to go, or first and goal. They hand off to Green over the middle, and he only gets a yard. A good shoestring tackle put on him.
Might be using a timeout right here, Ray.
As it was Kevin Moran who made the stop. Gain is 1, 2nd and 9, 1 minute to go till halftime, but Loya disdains the timeout. He goes with the no huddle. He'll be passing here, it looks like, and he's back to throw. He loops it over the middle, incomplete, and trying to hit Schwinner, but he was backpedaling and just underthrew him at the goal line. The clock stops with 49 ticks left till halftime, and the Duke leading 20-7, looking for more. Certainly they're in field goal range.
And Loya did a good job of just getting that ball off right here. Tremendous pressure, and he knew exactly where Schwinner was, so he said, let me try to take a shot, let me get it to him, and came up a little bit short, but still saved the 10-yard loss. He would have gotten it if he got the staff.
This was a 13-point edge, looking for more here in the late stages of the first half. And the two favorite receivers of Loya go to the right, Neely and Rosado. Back to throw, gets the heat. He throws it out there, tipped away, and nearly an interception as it was intended for Green coming out of the backfield. And it was Jeremy Gilbert who got his fingertips on that one, so the Dukes will go for the field goal.
Well, and let me tell you something, the Dukes got away with one there, because if Gilbert had caught that, he could have tipped it. If he had tipped that to himself, I mean, he had sort of clear ceiling for it. It would have been about an 85-yarder.
Mm-hmm. This is a 26-yarder for Bergman. He has 2 field goals thus far and a couple of extra points. 45 seconds till halftime. Kick is on the way, and the kick is perfect. And the Duke lead it now 23-7 with 42 seconds left till halftime over Wagner on the 26-yarder by Bergman.
The toe is outdoing himself today.
Well, that was a big lift for Duquesne after stopping Wagner, coming back, starting at their own 45, getting it down into field goal range, and tallying with 42 seconds to go. Now it's just a 16-point lead.
Okay, that was a big, because, you know, 20-7, 2 scores 21, you know, that's a big 3 points right there, because now you're over the two touchdowns, you know, deficit, unless you get 2 point conversions, you're down 16, but the traditional 2 7-point touchdowns just puts you out of that range. The 2 point conversion is certainly enlivened football. Allows for a lot of possibilities. 23-7, the Dukes lead it. And still, time on the clock here, 42-6 left till halftime. Bergman to boot it off, and the always dangerous Lockwood back there with Surreal, equally dangerous. Bouncing type kick, smart one at the 25, taken by Dorofsky across the 30 and rolled out of bounds at the 35-yard line.
I think it was a good decision by the Duke team for us to not kick it deep towards Lockwood and just, you know, say, hey, let's kick it short. We're getting a pretty good field position, but let's not risk the run back.
Trevor Osborne on the tackle. There, you think Miletic will be putting it up here. He has decent field position from the 35. 37 seconds till halftime.
You might even see Wagner kind of go underneath, trying to get, you know, a few, so 15 yards, but maybe get field goal range, to try to get the three back.
Brian Cornell, the deep safety for the Duke. Miletic back to throw. Gets pressure from Wojciechowski. He gets away from him. Gets more pressure. Now he's running back at his 20-yard line, looking up the field, and he'll run it and throw down the sideline incomplete. That took 12 seconds off the clock.
A great job by Wojciechowski, but, you know, Wojciechowski gets pressure on Miletic. I mean, Miletic used to being out there and his fullback giving him a lot of room to breathe, but Wojciechowski's doing a good job fighting off the fullback block and putting pressure right on Miletic.
And then Todd Amick put additional pressure on him, and the Duquesne secondary, you got to credit them, staying with the receiver.
When you take a look, I mean, Wojciechowski has Miletic right there, but he sort of makes them go away from what they were trying to do. And as you said, Amick here now takes another shot at him. Then he has some room to breathe, but there was an incomplete pass.
Miletic back to throw in the pocket. This time good protection. Now it breaks down. They're after him. And he's tripped up. He throws belatedly incomplete just as he was going down. It's an incomplete pass with 18 seconds to go till halftime. The Dukes leading 23-7 over Wagner. Third down and 10 for the Seahawks at their own 35-yard line. Might they just run the ball here to run out the clock?
That wouldn't surprise me in the least, Ray. I mean, it's one of those things that, you know, they might say, hey, let's run this thing. Let's get this half over with. It hasn't been a good one. Let's go inside the group and come back out.
Because an incomplete pass would force him to punt.
Right.
And that's exactly what they're doing. Lockwood comes over the middle, gets about 6 to the 41. Let's see if the Dukes stop the clock. 12 seconds to go till halftime. Clock moving as we're under 10 and ticking. It's fourth down. Looks like the Dukes are just going to let it run out. As we kick it down, that's the end of the first half of play here. In the ECAC Division I AA ball at Arthur J. Rooney Field on the campus of Duquesne University in Pittsburgh. And it's been all Duquesne as they lead the Wagner Seahawks 23-7 at the half.
While most car dealers sell used cars as a sideline, nobody but nobody sells more used cars than C. Harper Chevrolet, Geo, and Buick. Whether you want luxury or economy, C. Harper has more than 150 used cars and trucks to choose from. And at C. Harper, they'll stand behind your purchase mile after mile. C. Harper Chevrolet, Geo, and Buick, Route 51, Bell Vernon.
You can wake up like this,
or you can wake up like a champ. Wake up with the all-new Breakfast Jam on 106 Jam's WAMO. Containing only the finest ingredients. Nutritionally balanced for good, healthy fun.
Mark Gunn and Lisa Allen, along with Tracy Ross, Tony Giordano, and Debbie Norrell, are your all-new Breakfast Jam.
Now there's a new ingredient, Steeler Safety Carnell Lake.
So wake up with Carnell Lake and the all-new Breakfast Jam on 106 Jam's WAMO.
It's an amazing feeling. And of course, it's priced to thrill engineering. A never-before fusion of style, technology, and price. Featuring a fantastic lifetime valve that makes fail-proof faucets both possible and affordable. So fail-proof, they'll work flawlessly forever. Fail-proof, affordable, forever yours, priced to thrill. the fabulous Baltic with a funny name.
Okay, I'm out on the road talking to cars about BP Super 93. How do you feel with the Super 93?
I feel very, very good. It just goes through the intakes, and it just seems to make me run better throughout the day.
One day I made the mistake of getting a different gas. We won't mention it.
Yeah.
And not only did I chug, but I went right back to BP.
Well, there you have it. 9 out of 10 cars, when asked, recommend BP Super 93. BP on the move.
I've used 93 since first.
When
Seahawks come out, Maletic is the quarterback. Lockwood will dot the I from the 11. Lockwood gets the call. Right side, and he's nailed for a very short gain on the play.
You know, a lot of times in football, they say the most important series when you're down is the first series of the second half. And we can't have a tremendous opportunity there. If they can stop the Seahawks, they'll get great field position and be able to, you know, hopefully be able to move the ball down and get in scoring position, and it would be really turning this game into a one-sided affair.
Todd Amick, one of the tacklers for Duquesne there, a one-yard pickup, second down and 9. Maletic with Zarowski, the only setback, looks like a passing formation. He doesn't disappoint. He's back to throw, has time, sideline, and it is caught, and a quick tackle made around the 18-yard line. The receiver out there making the reception, it was Sean Hurley, as Marl Mons makes the stop for Duquesne. It's short of a first down. They'll mark it at the 18-and-a-half, third down, and about 4 to go for the first down.
And a big third down play here. Wagner's not done a good job in the first half on third down conversions, and here they're faced with another one, and it's a big, because it's really going to dictate field position on the next possession.
Let's see what Maletic does. He pitches to Lockwood, swinging to the right, and he has the first down as he gets out, or he's close to it, and they have been premature. Let's see where they mark him down.
I think you're right. They get in the first down. I think you got it.
That's a 23. Needed 4, got 5. Maletic getting the play selection as he comes in with Rick Surreal, one of his running backs. It's at the 22, actually. Just enough for the first down. The original line of scrimmage was the 11. Surreal will run from the tailback spot. Play action, Maletic getting heat, throws, incomplete. Good pressure by the Dukes there. Wojciechowski was one of the pressure people, and who was the other one, Rayo?
Wojciechowski and Rayo putting good pressure on Maletic. Does a good job of getting the ball off, but can't complete the pass, so they're bringing up a second down.
Here's some halftime stats here. The first down's 10-7 in favor of the Dukes. Rushing yards, the Seahawks dominating there, but look at the passing yardage, Brian. The Dukes 13-for-21 there. And 224 yards.
That's remarkable. I mean, Dave Loy has done an excellent job, as his receivers have done. And he's done a good job of preparing today to throw the ball against Wagner.
And it is Lockwood rolling to his right, finding no running room at the sideline. So Duke strung the play out, and he goes out of bounds around the 25-yard line. Don't forget the one pass by Nelson out of punt formation that kept that first drive alive for Duquesne.
That's right. It's a 19-yard there, so Loy didn't test it all too. 232.
Line of scrimmage, the 24-yard line. Pickup of only one. It is third down and 9 for the Seahawks. 13-10 to go in the third. Duquesne leading 23-7 in this ECAC Division I AA Bowl at Arthur J. Rooney Field on the campus of Duquesne University in Pittsburgh. Out of the shotgun, Maletic. Wide out both ways. Three-man pattern. Throws, overthrows, almost intercepted. And the top interceptor for the Duke, Sepik, had that ball slide right through his hand.
You know, he was right there, right? You know, he almost had too much time to think about it. He could see the ball coming right to him. What's this? What's happening? And just couldn't hold on to it.
He had 4 picks on the year, and he had his 5th one in his sights there. Frankie to punt to Rosado. The Dukes put some pressure on. They block one in the first half. Here comes Wojciechowski, but he gets it away. Send over in and short. Going to bounce around midfield and head out of bounds around the Duquesne 48-yard line. So the Dukes with terrific field position with 12:57 to go in the third and leading 23-7 over Wagner.
And, you know, as I said, it was a big series for the Duquesne defense and the Wagner offense. I mean, Wagner had to put something together there. They had to get back on the board. And instead, Duquesne defense comes up with a big play and gets the ball here in great field position.
Carmen Bustillo, the center, out over the football. And the quarterback is Loya, bringing the deep back in that offset eye. And he gets the call, swinging to the right. Gets out to the 48, just back to the line of scrimmage. They're very tough against the run, as their stats showed at the end in the first half. It was the Duquesne passing game that did the damage, as Jeff Ferlato and Bill Summers make the stop for the Seahawks.
Ryan Linder, also the outside back, is going to do a good job there. He sort of tried to sit him up, but Linder sort of stretched that play out to get some help. Good play by the Wagon defense.
Schwinner, tight end left. Neely to the left flank. Rosado to the right, the split end. Passing situation, and Loya's back. Fires. Rosado has it at the 40. Spun down around the 34-yard line. First down for the Duke in Seahawks territory, as the tackle is made by Jeff Ferlato.
Once again, right over the middle. I mean, I speaking to Coach Kikusa on the weekend, he mentioned to me that he put, Wagner, if you could throw against him, the place to throw with him was in the middle of the defense. So it's sort of a soft area, and they did a good job hitting Rosado in that area.
Duke up 23-7 and looking for more here in the third stanza with 12 minutes remaining. Split back, now Green reset. Handoff goes to the fullback, comes over the middle, fights his way down inside the 30-yard line, as it is Tim Gribble. He's a freshman from Brownsville.
He's a senior, right? Senior captain, Tim Gribble. Has done an excellent job for the Duke for 4 years. Really an overachiever. Doesn't carry the ball a whole bunch. He's talking to the coaches yesterday about getting 8 carries, and he'd like to get 8 carries. But I think that's his second on the day, so he's a little short.
Yeah. I blinked and looked at the wrong line there. Senior Tim Gribble, a veteran, at the 30-yard line. Pick up his 4, second down and 6. Again, the offset eye. Loya down the line to the left, hand off to Green. They run left. Green is dumped after a short gain inside the 30 around the 28-yard line. Good defense by the Seahawks against the run to the left that time. And over there, it was Mark Price, defensive end, making the stop for Wagner.
You see Billy Green's rushing yardage, 1,427 yards coming into today's game. Outstanding career. Bill has had a 700-yard rushing game this year. And he didn't have his first one until last year, the seventh game against Iona on ESPN2, and he's really coming to his own.
Third and 4 for the Dukes at the 28. Rosado, motion, fake, play action, rolling right, end zone. Man there, diving, couldn't get it, as it was intended for John Hart.
And the Dukes with a third and 5, they go for it all there. I mean, a good call, I think, by the coaching staff. And Hart had a break there and just ran out of some room.
Decision time for Greg Gattuso. Loya stays in the ball game, so they're going to go for it. Disdaining the field goal possibility, it'd be about a 45-yarder.
You take a look, Loya has plenty of room here. Throws it up, sort of lost it up just a little bit too high. You'll see Hart there in the end zone and just beyond his reach. I wouldn't be surprised if he's going to go something short here. That short hit that they did before.
And Loya fires, incomplete, through behind Rosado. Had good pressure on him, so the Dukes come up empty on that fourth down play. And Wagner will take over at their own 28-yard line. Neither team able to capitalize here in the third quarter. And the Dukes maintain their 23-7 lead over the Seahawks with 10:23 to go in the third quarter. Jason Malek in to run the attack for the Seahawks. Tito Lockwood will dot the eye. Dorosky the up back. And the pitch to Lockwood. Swing to the left and is met by the top tackler for the Dukes, Joe Neckerman, and he nails him for a loss on the play.
Another one of the fine leaders on the team. Ray's done a great job defensively throughout his career, and honored last week at senior day, but Joe Neckerman was right there and had an answer for that play.
Came into the game with 91 tackles.
You take a look at Neckerman and Lockwood one-on-one, and Neckerman wins that one.
Line of scrimmage to 26, the loss of 2, second and 12. Miletic will operate out of the shotgun with 3 wideouts. And Lockwood will probably come out of the backfield, although he stays back to block. Sideline completes to Daniel near the 30, flips 2 tacklers, flips the third one, but he can't get by them all. And he is knocked down finally around the 33-yard line.
Kevin Daniels did a terrific job, didn't he?
He did a terrific job. And it was remarkable. I mean, it was missed. You know, he flipped a tackle, flipped another one. So there was like four tacklers that sort of had a shot at him and couldn't get him down.
They always tell you to hit the guy low, and they were all headhunting here, as you'll get a look at it. One, two, three.
He said, Nithman, hold on. He got Steppich coming back. Coach.
Nithman finally took him down. Third down and five at the 33-yard line for the Seahawks. And again, Miletic out of the shotgun. Looking to his right. Man wide open. Catches it midfield and is tackled, or he goes a long way. As making the reception over there was Sean Hurley. And the tackle by Brian Cornell coming up for safety. But a big first down conversion by the Seahawks. Takes it to the Duquesne 47-yard line.
A nice throw by Miletic there. Good pattern run by Hurley. He sort of got into the seam in between the deep coverage and the shallow coverage. You see Miletic delivering the ball right in between the low coverage Mons and the up coverage to Cornell. Cornell, lucky to make that tackle. He goes a long way.
So Miletic will stay in the shotgun. Why not? It's been working. His team is down 23-7. This time he hands off to Duraski, who comes across the 45, 40, 35, and has a first down. He picks up 12 strong yards on the play, and coming up from the secondary, Brian Cornell from safety to make the stop.
Duraski does a nice job there. The offensive line does a nice job for the Seahawks, and I think a good call, cut the a little bit by surprise. They were expecting pass, and they weren't really ready at the point of attack.
Here comes Wagner. They're at the 34 of the Duke. The Duke led this ball game 13-0 at the end of one. And then Wagner scored to make it to 13-7, but the Duke got the last 10 points of the second quarter to jump out to the 16-point lead. But it's far from over. Pitch back to Lockwood, reading his block. Cuts it and gets inside the 30 around the 29. Picks up about five on the play. As defensively for the Duke, one of the tacklers there is Mike Orsi. And also helping out, it is Amick. Todd Amick.
Good job by the offensive line. Randy Marciano and Rick Grimaldi did a nice job leading the way for Lockwood there.
They spotted at the 30 of the Duke, so it's second down and six for the Seahawks with 7:34 to go in the third. 23-7 to tally. Out of the shotgun, Lockwood sets up in the slot to the left. Miletic has a man open to the right, and it is complete, and a good hit put on him at the 25-yard line as Mons takes down the receiver over there.
Archie Dean, the receiver on the play, Ray.
Just a short pattern. They gave him too much of a cushion.
Be able to take a look at it. You see him goes out and stops. He's got a little cushion there, and Mons closes, makes a good play, but they get about eight on the pass, and it brings up a third and one. A big play here.
This drive started at the Wagner 28-yard line. Looks for Lockwood to get the call, and he does. He swings to the right, and he's nailed for a loss on the play. Good penetration by the Duquesne defense. As they were all in there, Neckerman, Wojciechowski, and also down on the bottom, Orsi.
And I think the Dukes are ready for that play. Obviously, they picked it up and filmed during the week, but short yardage, they do a lot of sweeps. Because that's the second time Wagner's had third and short and went to the sweep we mentioned before. You take a look at it, I mean, the defense is sliding that way.
Line of scrimmage at 27. It's fourth and three, and obviously the Seahawks are going to go for it.
I mean, obviously, that's been their bread and butter play. Mm-hmm. Of course, all year. And Coach Hammond goes for it there, and good penetration by the Duquesne defense. I wouldn't be surprised seeing him back with it again.
Fake, play action, Miletic looking. He'll run it, and he's going for the first down. He ducks inside the 25, around the 23, appears to have it. Miletic on a roll right. Out of play action, takes it for what appears to be a first down.
He almost lost his footing there, too. He sort of slipped coming out of the backfield, as did Lockwood, but he did a good job of knowing where the sticks were and getting them.
They keep the drive alive, the Seahawks, and keep their hopes alive. They tally here. They go for two. They're right back in it. They're only down 16, and this is the third quarter, 5:59 to go. Lockwood in the slot. Duraski, the only setback. Miletic. A draw to Duraski, and he gets a couple of tough yards at that as the Dukes were waiting for him.
I think they're a little bit more prepared on that occasion. They were looking not only, you know, every other time they've been in the shotgun, they pass the ball. Now they're ready that they know there's an option of a run there. Duquesne defense is ready for it.
Mark Rayo in on the stop. It's a gain of one, second and nine.
look at the replay here, and you see Orsi right there doing a good job of penetration and meeting the ball carrier.
Gain of one, second and nine at the 22 of Duquesne for the Seahawks. Slot left. Play action. Miletic with good time. Now he rolls to the right. Down the sideline he goes. Takes a hit from Neckerman. And it's spun down. Is that a flag down or not? Yes, there is. A flag around the tackle at the 21-yard line. And we'll wait for the officials to unravel this one.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I didn't really have a good view of what went on. There was a lot of people, a lot of bodies over there, a lot of big bodies. And I don't know if there was a late hit or somebody pushing from behind. Or
Face mask. I was afraid of that in that situation. John Woodward, the official, indicating. And the walk-off will occur and hurt the Duke as this moves the ball down to the 16-yard line. The 5-yard face mask. Repeat the down, so it'll be second down. And about three to go for the first down. Ball closer to the 15. .5 to go in the third. This drive beginning at the Wagner 28. Neither team has scored here in the third quarter, so the Duke maintain their 16-point halftime lead, 23-7. Miletic out of the eye set. Lockwood gets the call. Over the middle, steps his way through there. And fights his way forward near first down territory. A host of tacklers bring him down.
There's another flag.
A late flag. When they're late like that, usually on the defense.
They have a little emotion there. That's a little flaring of emotion.
But the players picking each other up from the bottom. For the Duke, it's Kevin Coates in on the top.
The Duke's clapping the hands here. It looks like it's going to be against the Seahawks.
It is a personal foul.
Well, that's a big one. That's 15 yards, and now brings up a second. And, especially if it's a dead ball, then the play counts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what they're deciding. It's from the spot of the infraction. Actually had a first down on the play, so they'll move the chains and bring up a first, or are they? Let's look at what they're doing.
It'll be a first and 10 from this area, but still it'll be a 15-yard walk-off.
Well, they move it back to the 27-yard line.
I think it'll be a first down. You see, in the old days, right, when I coached in the old days, it would have been
first and 25.
And boy, that was a nightmare.
Clock indicator to start moving. Miletic will come out. With Lockwood, his only setback. Dorosky's in the slot to the right. Duke with four down linemen. Back to throw. Over to the right, it is Lockwood. He has a lot of blue shirts around him, and he's tackled as Monts comes up and knocks him down, and another flag flies at the 30-yard line. I was just about to comment a couple of plays ago. This game has been pretty much penalty-free, but now yellow flag dominating.
Yeah, nice job there by Mara Mons to make the tackle. One of Wagner's offensive linemen sort of came in a little bit late there, and we'll wait and see what the call is. You can see the call, Miletic and Lockwood are sort of a...
It's another face mask. Let's see if we can pick it up, Ryan.
See Mons here on tackle. I think it's
face mask.
It's Rayo. It's Rayo with the face mask.
Out of bounds there, yeah.
Right.
And this is a 15-yard face mask against the Dukes. It'll take it all the way to the 15 and give the Seahawks a first and 10 with 4:32 to go in the third.
And right where we were 2 plays ago. You can see Lockwood over 1,000 yards rushing here for his second year in a row and over 4,000 in his career at the line.
Out of the eye set with wideouts both ways. Miletic the quarterback. Lockwood on a pitch to the right. They shut him down, and he loses about a yard on the play. Depends where they spot it. Amick with good penetration.
Excellent job by Todd Amick, a transfer student here at Duquesne from Penn State. Played at Upper St. Clair, who's got a great program. Jim Render there, and good penetration there. He made the play on his own.
It's been a long drive with all the penalties. Second possession for Wagner in this quarter. The Dukes have only had the ball once. but neither team has scored. And these Dukes maintain their 16-point lead, 23-7, 3:48 to go in the third. Out of the shotgun with second and 11 at the 16, Miletic. Back to throw, looking left. End zone, man there. They go for it. Knocked away nicely by Nisman. And he just batted away from the intended receiver in the end zone. It was Sean Hurley.
Nice job there by Bobby Nisman, another one of the senior captains, a real outstanding young man, and nominated for an NCAA Quick Drive Scholarship, great student. You see Nisman, he sits back from his, in a safety position, and Hurley's there, you know, looking for the ball, but Nisman comes there and breaks it up.
Third and 11 for the Seahawks at the Duquesne 16-yard line. Shotgun again, why not? Miletic, sideline, and it is picked off beautifully. And coming in to make the great grab, it is Bill Steppich, his fifth interception of the year.
Plays on the ball tremendously. They just did a fantastic job. What a terrific play by Billy Steppich. You know, Miletic just lost it up a little too long, and Steppich did a great job of closing on the ball and making the catch. You see Miletic trying to throw the ball here. Trying to go to Dean, number 17, and Steppich comes right in front of him, closes on the ball, just like he's close.
And that stops a big threat by the Seahawks. What a momentum turner that was. The Duke with it at their own 9-yard line. Loya, the quarterback. And Green gets the call going left. Tough going, nailed right around the line of scrimmage. Well, the Dukes are content to keep that 16-point lead. They'd like to move the chains a couple of times here.
Well, you know, I think what you're going to see is Dukes be a little conservative down here. I mean, 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. They're deep in their own territory. I don't think they're going to try anything crazy. They don't want a quick score from Wagner. You know, if Wagner's going to score, they want him to drive.
Anthony DiPolito is the tight end to the right.
Jaden Mahaney, the tight end to the left. He's really an offensive lineman, but...
And Green gets the call again. Left side, tough yardage. May have gotten two out to the 10 that time. Very tough to run against this Seahawks ball club. As in on the bottom of the pile, the mark price for Wagner.
You know, you're a little suspicious when the tight ends line up with the number 74. You know, what you're going to do on that play. But Jason Henney's an outstanding lineman. Had an injury early in the year, come back from it, and has really contributed a lot to the success of the Duquesne offense.
Joe Rosato back in there, one of the favorite targets of Loya. He and Neely are wide right. Third and long eight from the 10. Let's see if Loya puts it up. Sprints out to the right. He's going to pass. They're after him. He fires down the field, and it is caught beautifully in the open field by Neely. He has only open running room ahead. He'll go all the way for the score. It goes 90 yards for the touchdown. What a toss by the quarterback Loya, and a great grab by Neely. And he goes the distance, and the Dukes have literally put it away, even though we still have 2 minutes in the third, 29-7, leading over Wagner.
Outstanding play both by Dave Loya and by Mark Neely. Just a great effort by Dave Loya to buy the time to be able to go to the ball. You're going to be able to take a look at it right here, Ray.
This is a keeper. Watch this.
Here's Loya just getting away from Griff. Two defenders bearing down on him. Just throws it. Neely just be able to reverse his body, stay in bounds, and he's clear sailing from there. 90-yard touchdown play.
Fantastic on both ends. How Neely in full stride threw that ball perfectly, mind, and a great catch by Neely, or rather Loya throwing it to Neely, and how he didn't go out of bounds even. Fantastic, and Bergman to add the extra point. And it's on its way. And the Dukes have jumped out here with that 90-yard play to lead it now by 23 over Wagner, 30-7 with 2 minutes to go in the third quarter.
That'll put Loya over 300 yards passing the ball, Ray, which I think the Duquesne school record 314, and Loya had 311 against Gannon earlier in the year, so he's closing in on a Duquesne University school record.
Boy, that's a replay you can show on ESPN. That was just absolutely fantastic.
Well, Mark Neely, you know, 2 weeks ago at St. John's had 8 catches for 225 yards. I mean, he had an outstanding game against St. John's. And many of the same things you're seeing today, he started at St. John's 2 weeks ago. He's had an outstanding career, but he's had an outstanding year, and he made a lot of small plays into big ones.
That has to be just about a backbreaker for Wagner now, Brian. They're down 23. I know you're an ex-coach, and you still have a whole quarter to go, but they're a great comeback team, but that one really cripples them.
Yeah, that really hurts. I mean, and really, from the thing, it's third and 10, you're on your own nine. You come up with a stop there, you get the ball back in Duquesne territory, you have good field position. Maybe you push one in by the end of the third quarter, it's 23-14. You're in the game. You know, your kids, that's a real backbreaker.
The play of the game thus far. What a thrilling play. Loyetta Neely, 90 yards for the score. And Bergman to boot it off. Thrill and Lockwood back to receive. Boy, he really gets into it. And Lockwood just watches it sail over his head into the end zone for the touchback. Special teams like that. There'll be 20-yard line for Wagner with 2 minutes to go in the third.
And the toes in full gear today, right?
He's had a great day.
Been kicking for the Duke for 4 years, done a great job. He's had his ups and his downs. Today's one of his major ups.
He's all smiles as he comes to the sideline. Greg Gattuso greeted him.
Hugh Ryan, the director of sports information at Duquesne, speaks very highly of Chris Bergen, one of our favorite student athletes. He used to have a Chris Bergman update every week. He had made 27 straight extra points. He sort of had an update of Chris Bergman every week in the game notes.
Miletic has running room, 25, 30, and has a first down around the 31-yard line as he came out of the shotgun, and Joe Neckerman made the stop for the Duke.
And I think you're going to see Wagner. I mean, they have to throw the ball. I mean, it's come to, and he can't sort of grind out. I mean, the best thing that can happen to Duquesne, and I'm sure Coach is, he'd love to see a 15-play, 7-minute drive, but I don't think Walt Hamline's going to cooperate on that one. I think you're going to see the Seahawks with a lot of sort of play action or short type of stuff, throwing the ball downfield.
Tim Jacoby replaces Todd Amick in the lineup for the Duke. Out of the shotgun again. Short pass, Lockwood catches it at the 33 and gets just a couple of yards as Sepich makes the stop around the 35-yard line. Pickup of 3, it'll be second down and about 7. Clock ticking with 1:12 to go in the third, and Duquesne with their biggest lead over Wagner, 30-7 in this ECAC Division I AA bowl here at Arthur J. Rooney Field. Quick snap. Miletic, a lot of time now they're after him. He fires off the hands of Lockwood, who was covered closely by Sepich.
Miletic very close to the line of scrimmage there. Just sort of delivered the ball right as he was coming towards the line of scrimmage, almost his over there.
Now it's third and long for the Seahawks, who have had to abandon their game plan here after that last 90-yard score by the Duke. Three wide receivers, two to the right, one to the left, as Miletic out of the shotgun has time. Fires right over the middle, and it's caught at the 44-yard line for a first down, and Sean Hurley makes the reception in Duquesne territory for the Seahawks.
Very nice catch by Sean Hurley, and he does a nice job. Miletic throws it a little bit high. Hurley goes up, makes the reception for a first down and a nice game.
They move the chains and the clock indicator to start moving. Final minute of the third stanza.
Take a look. Miletic back in the pocket at plenty of time. Good protection by his offensive line. You see Hurley here right in the middle of this. Once again in front of Cornell and over the linebacker.
Out of the shotgun once again. They roll Dorofsky to the right sideline. Miletic now being chased to the near sideline. And he'll run out of bounds, step out right around the 45-yard line and step it up from the secondary to chase him out. He lost about a half a yard or so on the play. Actually, a yard. They're going to mark it at the 46.
Miletic, a transfer from the University of Cincinnati, played Division I-A ball at the University of Cincinnati, transferred to Wagner, and he's done a real nice job leading the team this year.
Jim Higgins in at tight end. Jim Bogacki goes out of there. Wide out to the right sideline is Archie Dean. To the left, it is Sean Hurley. Worked out of the conventional snap. And the pitch comes to Till over the left side, fights his way inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Rick Surreal, I should say. Surreal carries, a freshman, and gets it on a good gain. It's to the 39 from the 46 to 7 yards, but still brings up a 3rd and 5. And that could be the final play of the third quarter as the clock winds down. that's it. The end of the third quarter here at Arthur J. Rooney Field on the campus of Duquesne University, with the Dukes leading the Seahawks 30-7 in ECAC Division I AA ball.
Overlooking Manhattan, the richest cultural center in the world, and at the top of the professional ladder. At Wagner College, you're reminded every day that your highest aspirations truly are within reach.
What's a girl got to do to get on one of these commercials? What would you do to be in a beer commercial?
Everybody here is bringing our city. I can see that tonight.
Yeah, I see the light.
I can't hear you.
You can wake up like this,
or you can wake up like a champ. Wake up with the all-new Breakfast Jam on 106 Jam's WAMO.
Containing only the finest ingredients.
Nutritionally balanced for good, healthy fun.
Mark Gunn and Lisa Allen, along with Tracy Ross, Tony Giordano, and Debbie Norrell, are your all-new Breakfast Jam. Now there's a new ingredient, Steelers safety Carnell Lake. So wake up with Carnell Lake and the all-new Breakfast Jam on 106 Jam's WAMO.
While most car dealers sell used cars as a sideline, nobody but nobody sells more used cars than C. Harper Chevrolet, Geo, and Buick. Whether you want luxury or economy, C. Harper has more than 150 used cars and trucks to choose from. And at C. Harper, they'll stand behind your purchase mile after mile. C. Harper Chevrolet, Geo, and Buick, Route 51, Bell Vernon.
The officials confer. Personal foul, so to be of the 15-yard nature. Right? Yeah, that's the one that brought him down as he was getting by a tackler. So that'll hurt Duquesne here as we open fourth quarter action.
Take a look, Malenica.
Kevin Daniel,
the winner of Neckerman with the play, and he does grab the play.
He tried to pull that hand back, like getting caught with it in the cookie jar.
Good call by the officials.
Line of scrimmage, the 15-yard line of the Duke. Jaroski, the only setback, trips left. Rolling left. Miletic looking, fires near the goal line. And is it caught? Yes, it is at the 1-yard line, as Archie Dean actually had his feet in the end zone, but he caught it coming back just inside the 1-yard line.
Yeah, his feet were breaking the plane, but when he had a contain back, his body toward the end, the ball never crushed the plane, so they'll give him a catch and a first down on inside the one.
So Wagner looking to try and get back in this. They're down 23 points, but they're inches away from their second score of the day. And they'll go with a full house backfield. Miletic, Lockwood, he's in there for the score. And Lockwood, with 14-17 to go in the ball game, tallies for the second time for the Seahawks to make it 30-13 in favor of Duquesne. The drive was 80 yards.
I thought the Seahawks would probably go for two here, but it looks like they're going to send Frankie in and go for one.
Unless they have the play on the fake out of there, you're right.
Take a look at the replay, and the Seahawks are going in for the touchdown.
It is Anthony Abruzzi who handles the snap from center and places it down. And the kick is on its way, and the kick is good. So it's a 30-14 count now as Carl Franke adds the extra point. And it is still with a big lead, but it's not over till it's over, someone once said, and they're only down 16 points now with plenty of time remaining in this one, 14-17. Remaining in the contest.
And that's probably why Walt Hamline chose to go for one, to put him down 16 is getting conversion.
It'll be up to the Duquesne offense to, if not score, at least consume some time on the clock.
You're right, Ray. I mean, I think right now, you know, there's 14, there's plenty of time left, and certainly games have turned around, but I think this is a real big possession. I mean, if nothing else, I think it'd be good to take some time off the clock and make it a shorter game. Also, on the other hand, a big cheer for the Wagner defense. If they can go
three and out,
force a three and out and get good field position, you know, then you might have a bowl game if they can score quick.
And they've had some Houdini-like escapes to advance their record 8-1 and get to this bowl this year throughout the season as Frankie will boot it off. End over end, headed down the near sideline, taken at the 7-yard line by DeFazio as he comes up, gets to the 25-yard line in that vicinity.
Nice job by Andy DeFazio. Does a good job, takes the ball, advances it to good field position. He's got a 20-yard return, and he's got a brilliant career ahead of him, Andy DeFazio, a freshman out of Plum High School here in Pittsburgh. He's done an excellent job for the Duke this year on special teams, backing up Billy Green, and also going to be playing outfield for the Duke baseball team.
Dave Loya to run the attack is Carmen Bacillo, the center, out over the football. Offensive guards are Andy Crocker and Jim Codman. Little misdirection back to Phil. Loya loops it out there, complete to his fullback coming out of the backfield out to the 38-yard line, is making the reception over the shoulder of Tim Gribble, the senior.
And Dave Loya really displayed excellent touch in that pass. And that pass would only be thrown a certain way. And, you know, he's running. He's a right-handed quarterback going to his left. So it's tough to turn your body as you see that. But he lost the ball perfectly to Gribble. And
ball goes to the 38-yard line. Out of the eye set with Green dotting the eye. He'll get the call, has a hole over the middle, but it closes quickly as he gets to the 40, defensively making the stop. Kevin Moran, a linebacker, who fought off the block to hold it to a 2-yard gain, second down and 8.
You have to give the Duquesne offensive line a lot of credit today, Ray. They've done a great job. Andy Crocker, Carlos Rivera, Carmen Brichtella, Jim Codman, and John Ciccarella all have done an excellent job opening holes and protecting quarterback Dave Loya.
Loya from the 40-yard line on 2nd and 8. Gribble, the fullback, gets it for about 3 yards to the 43-yard line. As defensively, the stop is made by Ryan Linder for the Seahawks.
After three quarters, Mark Neely, 4 receptions, 182 yards receiving the ball. Joe Rosado, 3 receptions for 44 yards. Todd Schwinner, 3 receptions, 66 yards. Loya, 14 of 24 for 308 yards going into the fourth quarter.
A great day already. From the 43-yard line, 3rd and 5 for the Duke. Split back, passing situation, and Loya's back to throw. Gets a blitz. They're after him, and they've got him for the sack as they came with the backers, and it was Ryan Linder who will be credited with a sack. A big play by the Seahawks, forcing the Dukes to punt.
And the first time they got to Loya, you know, as it may seem like, that's credit to the offensive line. Did a great job this afternoon, and it's the first time they got to Loya, but take a look at it here, and when you see Wagner, they come right after him, and there's nothing he can do on that one.
Punt formation for the Duke. Bruce Nelson, who passed out of punt formation the first time, will not do it this time. They're after him, but he gets it away, and it's a beauty. And a fair catch last touch, and it's grabbed by Duquesne on a deflection and going in for the touchdown, but there are flags all over the place, and picking up the loose ball for the Duke was Brian Cornell. That was a late part of the attempt at a fair catch, wasn't it, Brian?
Either way, you have to give the receiver the option to catch the ball, and I think Marmon's interfered in that he was too close. He was within you're supposed to give the receiver a yard radius to catch the ball, and I think that's what they're talking about right here.
Cornell ran in for the touchdown, but that's a call back. It was a late fair catch attempt.
But regardless if it's a fair catch or not a fair catch, you see the throw is the right thing.
Exactly.
The ball, and I think good.
But if he gives an illegal signal for a fair catch, that can be a penalty against him.
Absolutely.
And it could be offsetting perhaps.
Right.
But
or if you don't give a signal and or you give a half-hearted signal and you run with it.
Yeah,
you know, that's a penalty.
You have to give a clear signal, and it certainly didn't appear to be clear. Greg Gattuso arguing with the official on the sideline there, at least giving his opinion. But the walk-off occurs against the Duke, so they definitely didn't give him a chance to make the catch. At the 42-yard line, so Wagner puts it in play. Still backed by 16, 30-14, but a lot of time, 12:08 to go. The handoff from Sidorowski out of the shotgun, and he gets about 5 to the 47-yard line.
Lockwood with 20 carries so far this afternoon for 68 yards. Billy Green, 17 carries for only 24 yards. Not having a good day, but you know, we said early on that Wagner is a great team against the rush, and he's going to have to throw the ball, and boy, he's put up 308 so far. So. Melanick, on the other hand, is 12-22 for 137 yards for the Seahawks.
Second and a long five for Wagner out of the shotgun at their own 47-yard line. Good protection for Melanick. Right over the middle, the big tight end has it as he fights his way inside the 25 to the 22-yard line. Jim Bogacki, the 6'5", 260-pound senior, makes the reception and takes it all the way to the 22.
And a really well-thrown ball there by Malatiki. I mean, he had Bogacki over the middle, and he had to zip it in there, and he used it. He did a great job of seeing Malatiki. He's got great time. The offensive line's giving him good protection. He's got Budansky there, and he does a good job of zipping it right there ahead of Neckerman, and Cornell comes in to make the play.
Well, you don't want to meet him. It's like a runaway truck coming across. Pitchback goes to Lockwood, looking for running room. Flagged down as he's nailed at the 21-yard line. That's making the defensive tackle for the Duke. It was Kevin Coates. The flag occurred before the tackle.
Yeah, I think you're going to have a hold here.
Exactly.
A hold's going to be called on number 70, Matt Burns.
11:05 to go in the contest. 30-14, Duquesne leading, but Wagner threatening again here. Trying to pull one of their Houdini acts, as they've been able to do that throughout the season, to come up with that outstanding record of 8-1. Duke's a 9-1 coming in, the MAC champions. The holding call, though, goes against Wagner. The ball is marked off to the 33-yard line. First and 20 to go for the first down. They'll go out of the shotgun again. They have to go to the 13 of the Duke. Everybody out. Five-man pattern. Miletic being chased by Wojciechowski. Throws on the comeback, and it's incomplete. In and out of the hands of the intended receiver. Sepic on the coverage against Kevin Daniel.
Daniel did a good job of altering his route to come back to help Miletic out when Miletic's scrambling. And Miletic tries to deliver the ball, but Daniel just can't handle it. See Miletic here. He's back in the pocket. He has some time. Scrambles to his left, and he'll look for Daniels here, and Daniels does a good job walking the turn and try to come back, and just can't make the catch. Good play by Duquesne defender Bill Sepic.
Talking about escape, the Seahawks beat Stony Brook 28-27. They beat St. Peter's 28-24. They beat Monmouth 21-20. They beat San Diego 20-17. Those are some escapes. Over the middle, late out of the backfield, Lockwood has a 25 down inside the 20-yard line. A good gainer, but short of a first down, as making the tackle defensively for Duquesne, it was Matt Fisher. They'll mark him at the 19. 6 yards to go for the first down, third down.
And you know that the thought process here, you know, Walt Hamline's thinking we're in four down territory. We're not looking for field goals. We're looking for touchdowns. So this isn't a third and six. It's a third and a fourth down and six. Mm-hmm. I have two plays to get set.
Trip to the right. Surreal is in there. Has a wide out. Good block in the corner. Miletic has all kind of room. He throws end zone incomplete. I mean, he could have run for a first down easily.
He could have ran inside the 10-yard line. He had plenty of room. And I think, you know, he looked like he had a defender open in the end zone. I mean, a receiver open in the end zone. But we'll take a look at it. You can see the
great block here.
Taken out. And there's nobody there. I mean, there's nobody there. There's no defenders there. And he throws into an end zone, and there's good coverage there by Nisman.
Absolutely. Nisman knocks it away from the receiver, Daniel. So now it's fourth and six. Big play for both ball clubs. Still 9:56 to go. The Duke leading 30-14. The Seahawks have to get to the 13-yard line. Five receivers out. Over the middle. Big tight end has it. He's down to about the 2 or 1-yard line. as Bogacki at 6'5", an imposing target, and he put it right on the money. It's first and goal at the 2 for the Seahawks.
Well, it's starting to get a little hot here too, Ray. I mean, he's really delivering the ball well and sort of spreading it out. Goes to Daniels, take a look here. Hits the tight end right over the middle, right in front of Neckerman. Cornell comes in to make the tackle, and Seahawks in business here, first and goal on the 1.
Out of the eye set. Lockwood ducks the eye. They'll pitch it to him. He sweeps to the left. He has running room, and he's in for the score. Lockwood tallies, and look out. Wagner back in this one with 9:29 to go, now trailing 30-20 on the 2-yard official run for Tito Lockwood.
There's an injury in the end zone here, Ray. Somebody, I think it's Lockwood down, but he looks to be okay. He's getting up. Here's the toss to Lockwood. He's getting into the break, his nip and his tackle, and he's in the end zone for the touchdown.
Now you think they're going for 2, don't you, Brian?
Well, one would get him within 9, Ray. I mean, it would be within a 9 where a touchdown and a field goal would win it.
Now they're going to go for 2. They got their offensive set in there.
2, they go for 2 here, a touchdown and a 2-point conversion ties it.
Right.
And this game is being played under NCAA championship rules that if it's tied, it would go into overtime.
Back to throw. They're after Miletic. The incomplete as it's knocked away. The ball is loose. As the play was made by the Duke, Mark Rayo, he foiled that one, and the Duke maintained an important 10-point lead, which is a 2-score lead with 9:29 to go, leading Wagner 30-20. And with 9:29 to go, and the Duke leading this by a 30-20 count, the Seahawks will be kicking off. Still plenty of time remaining in this one, and the Duke need to consume some clock as they're getting some instruction on the sidelines.
His defensive coordinator, Ollie Phillips, there, talking to his defensive unit. Doesn't look very happy.
That drive was 80 yards, Brian Sutter, back in the third quarter. Booting it off, it'll be Carl Franke.
This is when your Duke King fans keep looking at that scoreboard clock and
can't go fast enough.
Yeah, you know, I said it earlier, you know, as we start the fourth quarter, one thing you want the Duke King offense supposed to do is just consume some time. Take some time, make it a shorter game.
Rosado at the 11th, running diagonally, gets a break at the 35-40. Foot race to the near sideline, 45-50. He can motor down the sideline. He goes finally out of bounds. A great return by Rosado to the 31-yard line, that vicinity. He can fly, Rosado.
Very skilled, he's done an excellent job in all phases of the game this season. We can take a look at it here, but he's got good blocking right at the point of when he gets the ball, and he breaks sort of at the 20-yard line. He breaks in the open. Here you see him taking this right on the 10. And here's where he just breaks the seam right here. He goes right through the seam, and then he's off to the races and caught by the kicker. Frank does a good job. He takes a good angle and sort of catches up to him and saves the touchdown for the Seahawks.
57-yard return to the 32, and Green gets a couple of tough ones to the 30 as making the stop defensively was Justin Abel. We wind it down, 9 minutes to go in the ball game. Duquesne leading 30-20 over Wagner, but the Seahawks coming back here in the fourth stanza. Duke's in excellent field position if they can punch another one in. Neely and Rosado go wide to the right, out of that offset eye. The pass, man open there. Rosado has it out in the right flat. Breaks a couple of tackles, still on his feet as he fights his way inside the 20 to the 17 for a first down. What a run by Rosado after making the pass.
And he's done that all year, right? He has tremendous ability of being able to catch a short ball and using his athletic ability to cut and pick up additional yardage. And a good throw there by Dave Loyal. Excellent delivery. You take a look at it here and you see Rosado does a short out. He's got the ball, he catches it on about the 24. Could have been right there at the 24, but uses his athletic ability, breaks a couple of tackles, and picks up an additional 7 yards.
And up for the first down. trips left. Loya with Green, the only setback. And he'll get the call as he thunders to left. 15, on his feet at the 10, down to the 9, 8-yard line, that vicinity. Green with one of his best runs of the day. And the tackle defensively is made by Ryan Linder, or Green goes in for the score at the 9. It's an 8-yard pickup, 2nd and 2.
And Crocker and Rivera do a great job on the left side of that offensive line. Take a look at the dribble with the lead block there, and Rivera and Crocker downfield. Also Cotton down there.
Rivera, nice field block. As the Dukes come out again from the 9-yard line, they'll set up in the eye. Loya, dribble over the middle, first down as he gets down near the 5-yard line. Dribble running hard as the stop is made by Vincent Fife. First and goal for Duquesne.
And the Dukes want 7 here. They don't need 3, they
right.
Need to get 7. 7 puts it to 17 and makes it 2 scores, or 3, you know, needs 3 scores. 3 points even 14 is a 2-score game, so.
Jason Henney in there, the offensive left tackle for the Dukes. Out of the eye from the 5-yard line, first and goal. It is Green, hole over the middle, fights his way forward, he's down near the goal line, but he can't quite fall in. He stopped at the 1-yard line.
Great effort by Billy Green there, and a great effort by the offensive line. They did a great job of controlling the line of scrimmage.
They did set up on this drive from the 32-yard line on the 57-yard kickoff return by Joe Rosato. The key to this game is that every time that Wagner has gotten a score, they just come right back to get a score and keep them at bay.
They've had answers so far this afternoon. They've answered every challenge.
They'll come out in the full house backfield with Green, the left halfback. Dribble is the fullback. Dribble gets the call. Left side. Touchdown. Standing up. And the Dukes have put this one away with 6:24 to go, leading 36-20 over the Seahawks. They need the extra point, though, Brian, to get that 17-point lead, because 2 8 would make it a 36-all game when you think like a coach, and I know you do.
Take a look at it. Good job by the offensive line. You see Jason Henney in there playing tight end, and does a good job of caving down, and Timmy Gribble does the rest. It's Timmy's third carry of the day. He's getting close to that 8.
And Bergman, the toe, will attempt the extra point. There's a couple of field goals, and this one is up there, and it is good. And he gives the Dukes a 37-20 lead with 6:24 to go in the ball game. Bergman has been outstanding.
Rizzo.
The Dukes lead it to 37-20 over Wagner with 6:24 to go in the ball game in this ECAC Division I AA ball in Pittsburgh.
In a world of conflict, we bring peace through understanding. In a world of economic distress, we bring prosperity through learning. In a world of ignorance, we bring knowledge through advanced technology and brilliant teachers. In a world of despair, we bring hope to thousands. In this complex world, the solution is education for the mind, the heart, and the soul.
Caught at the sideline, but stepping out of bounds is Rossi. A little bit of contact as he went out of bounds.
Yeah, but Matt Fisher real close to getting a personal foul there, but you know, I think it looked a little bit.
He held up worse
than it. Yeah, it looked like he was going to try to throw him out of bounds, and he held up and made a good decision.
The line of scrimmage is still the 13-yard line, so no gain on that pass out to Dorosky on the left flat. The out of bounds play does stop the clock. 5:52 to go. And Duquesne leading 37-20 over Wagner. Four-man rush. Miletic steps up in the pocket. They're after him, and they've got him. Down he goes, and Wojciechowski on the ankles makes the tackle. He's had an outstanding game.
And an outstanding career. He's been, as I said, he's a fine young man. He's a great student, and
look at it. Mlenik has plenty of time here. He's got sort of plenty of time, and Wojciechowski tries to get the ball, does a good job, and gets him from behind.
A loss of one, so the sack for Wojciechowski. Third down and 28 to go. And this time, Mlenik will go under center on the snap. Rolls to his right. They're after him. Goes deep down the middle into coverage, and it's almost intercepted. Nisman had it and dropped it as Lockwood made contact with him. Lockwood was coming down for the reception, but it was Nisman who was ready to fair catch that ball.
Mlenik said it just—he airs it out here. He just throws it up, and Nisman's sitting back there, and it's overthrown. And Lockwood is over his head.
Punt formation coming up as Frankie is back there to boot in his own end zone. He gets it away, end over end. Rosado fair catches it, dives, makes a nice reception in Wagner territory around the 42-yard line. So the Dukes in command here, Brian. 4:56 to go, leading 37-20 over Wagner. Dave Loya remains in at quarterback. What an outstanding effort by the Dukes of Greg Gattuso. Trips to the right, but I don't know that Loya will be passing much here. Takes the snap, Green gets the call, cuts to his left, goes to the corner of the 40, running room at the 35, bulldozes his way down to the 30-yard line. He's starting to pick up some yardage here late in the ballgame.
You know, if you notice, Ray, the last four plays of the last series and the first play of this series was all to the left side. You know, and that's, it's been their bread and butter all year. They've been very successful going left, and you have to give a lot of credit to, as I said, the offensive line, and Carlos Rivera, Andy Crocker, and Jim Todman, Ciccarello, Priscilla.
At the 30-yard line, first and 10 to go for the Dukes. Just right, but if you're the Seahawks, you've got to kind of figure number five is going to get the ball. Green gets the carry. Left side again. Inside the 25 to the 23. He gets seven. And defensively, Ryan Linder helps on the tackle for the Seahawks. The Dukes keep the clock running. 4:10 to go in the contest, leading 37-20.
Nice job there by tight end Anthony Cipollito. He did a good job of opening a crease there for Green, and Green takes advantage of it and picks up seven.
Again, Green the only setback as Loya sends trips to the right. But he's been running left out of this formation. This time they run to the right, and Green goes to the first down. They have it just inside the 20-yard line as the hole opened up, and Bill Summers makes the stop for the Seahawks. He's just inside the 20, so he'll have a first down, and the Dukes will get a fresh set of downs with 3:29 to go.
Dave Loya using a lot of that 25-second clock, getting up to the line of scrimmage and letting the clock tick down.
He put trips to the left this time. Play clock is down to 9. Neely comes in motion across the play flow. Green again. Whole left side. Inside the 15, down around the 14-yard line. Perhaps a little bit of a fight has been taken out of the Seahawks at this point.
Well, you're on the road. Cold afternoon, and the race just didn't go the Seahawks' way. I mean, every time they seemed like they were going to come back, you couldn't have an answer, and it's tough right now as these kids to be out there playing, and knowing that there's nothing we can do right now, sort of out of our control.
Second down and 5 for the Dukes at the 15-yard line of the Seahawks. Six left again, Green the only setback. Dribble comes in motion. Green again, goes to the outside, 15, 10, 5, touchdown! Bill Green goes 15 yards for the score, and with 2:21 to go, Duquesne leads it 43-20 over the Seahawks.
Great job by Billy Green, great job by the offensive line, and Kenny Dribble leading them, and just a great overall effort there.
performance by the Dukes on both sides of the ball. They've had some big plays, but if you watch Green cutting back and going to the corner, getting some great downfield blocking, cut to the 10. Rosado, a good block there, and he fights his way into the end zone for the score. Bergman for the extra point, and he's been flawless, and he boots it through there, and the Dukes lead it 44-20 over this Wagner Seahawks ball club as the Duquesne cheerleaders, they're cold, but they're happy. Well, we've had some big plays in this game, and the Dukes now lead it big time, 44-20, with a clock showing 2:21 to go as the Dukes will win this Division 1AA ECAC bowl.
In a world of conflict, we bring peace through understanding. In a world of economic distress, we bring prosperity through learning. In a world of ignorance, we bring knowledge through advanced technology and brilliant teaching. In a world of despair, we bring hope to thousands. In this complex world, the solution is education, the mind, the heart, and the soul. Duquesne University.
Greg Gattuso, in his third year at Duquesne, what a job he has done.
He's done an excellent job, right? You know, and he's done it sort of the right way. You know, there was sort of a plan put in place, and he's executed it perfectly.
Miletic remains in at quarterback, and he's back to toss. Out to the left, complete to Dorofsky, and he slips down at the 42. I think that about capitalizes the frustration of Wagner. It's just in Duquesne's day. Still never forget that 90-yard pass. I think that was a backbreaker in this game.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, that was just that one of those plays that really turned the whole tide of the game. Just when it was starting to turn for Wagner's favor and Wagner had the momentum, that sort of broke it back.
Game is only one. The pass complete to the 45-50, and a hit put on Kevin Daniel as he gets to the Duquesne 48-yard line. First and 10 to go for the Seahawks, but we're down to a minute 36 to go in the contest. And all Wagnerson has to do is score and try to make it a little closer.
There's Malenik here, and Daniel just goes out and does a short stop, and does a good job after catching the ball, beats Mons there. And Christian Cici comes in, makes the tackle.
This pass to the left, complete, and out of bounds around the 42-yard line is the receiver, Archie Dean. So they stop the clock with 1:25 to go. Line of scrimmage, the Duquesne 42-yard line. Second down, and four to go for the first down. Miletic will come out of the shotgun again with twins left, and they're wide out to the right side. Gets good protection. Fires down the sideline. Man there, over the shoulder grab, and out of bounds around the 20-yard line. Making a catch with Sean Hurley. Well-thrown ball by Miletic at the 20 of Duquesne with a minute 20 to go. Duquesne defense would like to keep him out of the end zone, though, Brian.
Well, I think so. Here is Miletic dropping back. There's plenty of time. Duquesne obviously playing a little prevent defense and stepping underneath. And Andy Kwiatkowski makes the play, a freshman from Moeller High School in Cincinnati.
From the 20 with a minute 20 to go in Duquesne territory, drive started. To Wagner 40. Quicklin comes out here, complete to Daniel at the 15, trying to get out of bounds, but he didn't do it as the Dukes double team him.
Brian Cornell in on the tackle there, right?
Matt Toffoli also helping.
Matt Toffoli also.
1 minute to go in the ballgame. The clock is moving, and it's an official trying to get it to stop. Don Woodward, a timeout called by the Seahawks with the Dukes leading 44-20. They'd just like to get in one more time, make this a closer ball game. But the Dukes have wrapped this one up with an outstanding performance. Duquesne led 13-0 at the end of one, 23-7 at the end of two. 1 minute to go in the ball game, and the Dukes lead at 44-20 over the Seahawks as you look at the city of Pittsburgh.
In a world of conflict, we bring peace through understanding. In a world of economic distress, we bring prosperity through learning. In a world of ignorance, we bring knowledge through advanced technology and brilliant teachers. In a world of despair, we bring hope to thousands. In this complex world, the solution is education.
Yard line with Brian Colleary. Ray Goss reporting to you. 1:08 to go. They put 8 seconds on the clock because it ran when the officials wanted to stop. Miletic will try to get the Wagner ball club into the end zone one more time before this one is history. Out of the shotgun, he gives off to DeRossi. Comes over the middle. That one didn't go too well as he got down around the 13-yard line. They'll go with a no huddle.
That keeps the clock ticking, too. Although it's irrelevant at this time.
52 seconds to go. Otto shotgun again. They have third and about 2.5 to go for the first down. Miletic looking. He has running room. He'll take it for the first down. Cut at the 10. On the 5. Try to get out of bounds. And he runs backward and is nailed around the 8-yard line. And that defending the clock does not stop because he didn't get out of bounds. Good pursuit by the Dukes to keep him out of the end zone.
Stop the clock because it's the first down. So they'll stop the clock while they move the chains.
It's first and goal. They could forget the chains. But it's at the 9-yard line. As we'll watch Miletic with a lot of room to his left, and he sees it.
Okay. See Miletic here, he's trying to get in the end zone, and then he's also saying, well, maybe I ought to stop the clock. He tries to get out of bounds, doesn't get out of bounds, gets the first down. Wagner's called a timeout.
Sepich and Neckerman chase him down with 38 ticks left, and the Dukes leading 44-20. Duquesne players on the sideline, they've been hugging each other for quite some time now because they know they have this one put away as the Dukes have dominated every quarter in this one. Wagner's made a couple of attempts. They were the closest they were with 13-7 in the second quarter, but the Dukes got the last 10 points of that quarter, and they've had answers for every threat that Wagner has thrown up with him.
Exceptional afternoon for sophomore quarterback Dave Loya. Mm. As I mentioned, I mean, he wasn't even starting quarterback come the beginning of the year. He was in an intense competition with a senior, Brian Staines. Basically, he took over in the second game. The Dukes lost that game, but now look on the verge of winning their ninth straight under his leadership. I mean, he's certainly been an integral part of this victory today.
Ball closer to the 8-yard line, so officially at the 8 as they throw down to the 3-yard line, a completion on a play as Duquesne makes the stop with Damian Petragic in on the tackle on the receiver.
Clock's ticking. I don't think Wagner has any more timeouts left, so they try to line up, try to get in the end zone one more time.
They're at the 2. And yes, one more apparently, Brian. Well, that was the third one.
They sure took their time calling that one.
Yeah, with 19 ticks left. And the final timeout called by the Seahawks. They have it at the Duquesne 2-yard line. But the Dukes have the game in tow, 44-20. Well, the Dukes will end the season with a 10-1 record, and that's always a tremendous, when you can get 10 wins in one season, that is an excellent effort, and of course, the bowl.
I think it's been an outstanding season. As I said, you know, this will be a Dukes ninth straight win, you know, they had their tough time. They went to Marist, and they were up 16-0 at half, and Marist came back 16-14, had a field goal attempt in the final seconds, a very short field goal. It was blocked, and it was sort of one of those types of years that the Dukes found ways to win and starting to believe in themselves.
See what they do here. They run with the set out of the quarterback. Miletic will roll to the right, fire in the end zone, in and out of the hands of Lockwood. Lockwood had it and couldn't hang on. So with 15 seconds to go, they're still at the 2-yard line.
And they're really left with no choice here. I mean, it's either they throw the ball or, you know, if they run and don't get in, the game's over. So take a look at it. He rolls the corner. I thought Malenik was going to run it here, and he sort of gets locked with him.
It was slightly behind him, but
yeah,
catchable.
Yeah, definitely catchable.
Repos are so good. You could see it was slightly behind him there, but... out of the shotgun, Miletic, third down. Look, he'll run to his left. Will he try to run it in? He ducks down. Did he get in there? No signal. And if there's no signal, he is down and injured, apparently, with 4 seconds to go. The official stopped the clock there because of the injury to Miletic, as they're concerned about him. Let's take a look at this one.
There's Malenik going through this. There's a freshman, Andy Kwiatkowski, and Carmen Bertella. Meet him right at the goal line, and the officials indicate it's not a touchdown. They're going to put the ball down on about the 6-inch yard line.
They're in the pond. Damian Petrakis?
Is that Damian?
He's
Petrakis.
The one that put that big hit on. Okay, they waved off the last 4 seconds of the ball game, Brian. Very interesting because the quarterback very concerned for the health of Jason Miletic, who was hit right down near the goal line. They're attending to him. This game is history. The Dukes win it by 44-20 to capture the ECAC Division I AA bowl here in Pittsburgh.
Well, you know, I think Walt Hamline, head coach of Wagner, went out and told the officials, hey, you know, this isn't going to make any difference. Let's just wind this clock up and let's get this over with and you know, instead of keeping everybody around. And
a great effort by the Dukes as they win it. Dave Loya certainly outstanding, over 300 yards passing, tremendous receptions, but the big play of the game, the 90-yarder to Mark Neely back in the third quarter of this ballgame to kind of put it away for Duquesne as the players exchange handshakes. Just a terrific effort by the Dukes, who win the bowl game here. The final score, Duquesne wins it by 44-20 over Wagner. For Brian Colleary, Ray Garth, bidding you a pleasant good day.